Hello there, guys and girls. The Welsh Hunter here with, as always, another 100% achievement guide. But this time, it is a bit of a cracker in the terms of the medium. Now, this Xbox Series X slash S exclusive was developed and published by Bloober Team. And to buy and keep will cost you £41.74. But it was on day one release on Xbox Game Pass. So, as always, I urge you to get Game Pass. Cancel that OnlyFans subscription and get Game Pass instead. So we play as a medium, Marianne, in a psychological third-person horror type environment where we have to discover and uncover the truths about a few of the game's weird characters. Now, disturbing secrets come out as we get through it by playing two realities at the same time while solving different and dueled up puzzles. Now, achievements-wise, this game is not very difficult, to be honest at all. There are a lot of story-related achievements, only a few miscellaneous ones, and that includes having to sneak past the giant monster called the Maw without being seen, but a little bit more on that later on. Now, the big boy of all is getting all of the collectibles. Now, you think it would be fine to miss one, as there's always chapter select in games, right? Wrong! Syphilis, herpes, STDs... Wrong video. But seriously, there is actually no chapter select in this game, meaning if you do miss one, you will have to go through the entire game again, so just make sure to pay attention and grab everything that you can before moving on. Also, to help with it, I've put every collectible on screen writing as we approach it to help you a little bit more. Oh man, I thought nice. So you should be looking at around maybe 5 to 6 hours to finishing the game, maybe more, a little bit less, depending on if you keep up with me fine on here. So with all that being said then, let us finally begin. Now obviously, as you would have seen, you would have had to adjust your brightness. Obviously the brighter the better, so you don't poop yourself. Although it's not really that kind of game, there's only a couple of jump scares in it, I promise. But as you will notice immediately, this doesn't play like a normal modern third-person shooter, if you will, say Fallout, etc. But it is more of a tank-controlled Resident Evil slash Silent Hill 1 and 2 from the early PlayStation days, sort of vibe controls. And that's where the camera angle changes wherever you go and sort of shifts perspective and sometimes momentum. So this is where we begin then. We'll just begin nice, happy, in our house, have a little feel about how Marianne moves. She moves kind of clunky, like me in real life. But the first thing we're going to be doing then is heading up the hallway. And we're going to be heading into the left bedroom there. Obviously, there's nowhere else to go because nothing else is open. So again, like I said, you know, there's a lot of things you can interact with and everything. But obviously, just to save time, I'm obviously just going to not do that and also skip through all of the dialogue and skip through all of the cutscenes. But I urge you to watch and read all of them as it is. It's a very fantastic story. Really enjoyable. So, what we're going to be also learning about then is an insight we can use. So, press and hold B to activate insight. That sort of puts you into a new perspective, but you can see things which you could not originally see. So as you can see, now you've got to press the X button. That will make the clock shift out of the way. And then you can pick up the item of what we need. When you come out of insight, you can't actually move the clock. So it's quite a few times in the game we'll be doing that. But again, make sure to remember that you have to use insight for at least 15 minutes in one playthrough. So you could literally just stand here right now, press and hold in the left bumper button just to get that achievement unlocked out of the way if you want to. But of course, we'll be using it a lot through the game. So head down the hallway, now turn right. And now we're going to go up. So it does take a little bit of getting used to. And then head into the right, into the kitchen. We're going to see a empty cat bowl. So have a look on the sort of kitchen counter. And we're going to see some delicious looking cocky lakocky. Of course, I'm not Polish, so I pronounce that like a typical British person. But get the cat food, head back to the bowl, and this will get us our first missable achievement, famished felines for feeding the cat. So if somehow you miss this, of course, it literally only takes 2 minutes in the game, so we're not too bad. But remember to grab the cat food, put it in, and then feed that little skinny pussy. So here we go then. Now we have to... This is our first collectible. You can't really miss this as we need it to move on. But we have to be doing a little bit with these developing photos. It's it is extremely easy enough. Literally, that's all you're doing is just following instruction. And if you can't, then, well, I'm very sorry for you. So pick up the paper first. And then eventually, and then put it on the sort of tray or the board next to it. And that's going to turn it into illumination paper. After you turn it on, of course. That always helps. So you'll have to do that for 5 seconds. So count to five. Sorry, I should have really counted to five with you then, but I'll do that better this time. And then literally all you're doing then is just going through each dipping. We're going for a triple dip. Now that's always a good orgy, that one, triple dip. Make sure to do it though for 3 seconds each. And then it should come up with multi-graded, then the next bit, and then the photo of Jack.
Photo I took of you, Jack. Shit.
Jack there looking more like a crap hitman, sort of Agent 69. So, anyway, what we're going to do now is head to the sort of character's right, and then we're going to head out of the door now, the sort of front door. And it's basically, a lot of times in this game, it is just a sort of linear path. Of course, there are times you can miss collectibles and everything, but for a lot of it, it is just sort of one long linear path. So for now, like I said, all we're doing is just heading downstairs at the moment.
Jack taught me to accept my condition. Of all my foster parents, he was the only one who saw it as a gift and not a curse.
And then when we're here, we're going to be taking the first right and unlocking the door. By the way, I kind of feel like the last goodbye funeral home, that genuinely seems like one more big kick in the teeth for a funeral home name, to be honest. Could have made it a bit cheerier, although death's not exactly fun really, is it? So anyway, once we're in here, we've got a few little things we're going to be doing before the spooky stuff starts kicking in. So head to, head down on yourself and go through the open door. It's going to be kind of complicated to explain sort of right and left and where we've got to go everything. Again, you can have a look around if you want to, but we're going to immediately just look on the desk. There is Agent 69 and us, but that is the main thing that we need, the prep room key. Because we can't be doing no prepping without it. So, like I said, you know, there's a lot of interesting stuff that ties in really nicely to the story. So, again, if you want to have a little look around the rooms and everything, absolutely worth it. But head back up and go into the prep room. Obviously, use the X button and go to the prep room key. Unless you're that good at breaking in with the Jack's little tie clip there, then be my guest again. So we're just going to head down the stairs, nothing in this little room here. But thankfully Marianne does end up learning how to run a little bit later on in the game. Apparently she's forgotten. Grief and all that, you know, you forget how to run and stuff, don't you? So head through the door, the only door that is here. And now we're going to see our sad, sad Agent 69. All passed on. Obviously 47 got the better of him this time, so head straight on and take a look at the incinerator, I want to call it. I'm probably wrong, please don't laugh if I am wrong, but there's only one we can interact with, and now we are going to pull out. You've actually got to pull him out yourself, so press down on the left stick and pull out Agent 69, and then just take a little look at him.
Got your special clip? No. Where's your tie?
So now that we've got Jack's clip, turn around and you're going to see his tie directly on the chair. What we need to do then is just press A or the X button, combine it with the clip, and then we should be good to go. Could have done this before you chucked them down, would have made your life a lot easier, Marianne, but that's fine. So what we're going to do now, just interact with him again, give him his little tie and clip, and this little cutscene's going to happen. So like I said, I'm just going to be skipping through every cutscene and all the dialogue again. It's just to save time on the video, but it's definitely worth watching the cutscenes as some brutal and some awesome stuff happens. Now we're getting into the complete poopy pants section now, where we're going to start seeing shadowy figures and everything, so we're just going to head back up for a second. So, as is the norm in most horror films and games, always go into the room where the door closes on its own. Yeah, of course, that obviously happened. But what we're going to do is just head towards the sort of middle of the room this time and interact with the thing on the floor. I think it's the broken vase. Where in reality, I'll be getting my skinny white ass out of here. Anyway, cutting's going to happen. Again, I just skip it, but feel free to watch.
Oh, where is that darn notebook? I'm going to be late. I need to find that. Marianne? Marianne, are you...
Most people would give anything to have that opportunity. To say all the things that were left unsaid.
Oh, so that's how Agent 69 died. Now, I think when he meant he wanted a hole on his face, I don't think he meant a literal one through his head. But that's okay. Well, welcome now. After we get through all those cutscenes, we now have to be trying to reach the Neva Hotel. So we're going to get our first postcard, our first proper collectible. So have a look in the sort of building to the left. We're going to get the last goodbye achievement as well. But the postcard is basically the only thing we can interact with in the sort of middle of the room again. Just pick it up again, use the X button, and that will come up on the left. Now, also make sure that some of the collectibles will count and come up on the left-hand side there, but others, such as memory shards, will not. So some sort of count and look like on screen, but others do not. Again, as long as you're going through the whole video with me, you should be fine anyway. So just head sort of round the side now. We're going to be climbing up over the bin and we're going to be climbing up over the wall. So yeah, things like memory shards. Like there's a lot of collectibles in this game, such as eerie drawings. But I'll be collecting these eerie drawings, but they don't count towards an achievement. But again, just collect everything that I do in the video anyway. You'll be fine. And again, I'll explain a little bit more when we come up to them anyway. So now, Marianne for some reason has remembered how to run. She can ride a motorbike, but she couldn't run earlier. So again, it is sort of just again one long linear path. There's going to be a cutscene that happens when we get to the bottom of here now. And then it's literally just a case of following the one path down.
Hello.
And again, what you will see quite a bit of is me sort of just using the insight, even when we don't need to use it, you know, just to get some minutes on the clock to get the achievement. For you, again, you've got to use your insight for at least 15 minutes in one playthrough. So that's why you'll see the screen sort of change to insight mode now and again, even if I don't use it. So just be aware.
What's this?
So head through the rightmost hole. It's a big hole, you can stick your whole head in there as well if you want. But there is a gate that we could be going through, and this is where, as soon as we get through this tiny little butt crack in the wall, this will be the first time where we are introduced to the sort of dual reality spec. So it's basically Marianne as a blonde in what looks to be hell. It is in another alternate reality, but we basically play the two characters at the same time. So whatever we do in one world, Marianne will be doing in the other world, as you'll be able to see now. So it's going to help us on both counts. So, yeah. So here we go then. So have a look on the right. We're going to be heading up now. Heading up this little ledge, and then immediately go to the right. And there's a left and a right you can go to. We're going to be going to the right. And on the ground, as blonde Marianne, you'll be able to see this eerie drawing. Now, as I said earlier on, eerie drawings are things that you can collect, and again, ties to the story very, very nicely, but they are not worth anything in terms of achievements. So if you miss any eerie drawings, seriously, do not worry about it. It doesn't matter at all. Now, as you can see, we need to be going through this gate in the real world, but of course we can't. So blonde Marianne's going to have to help us out here. Now, what do you prefer? Blonde? Brunette? I'm a sucker for a blonde myself. I really, really like blondes. But that doesn't have anything to do with anything. So go to the left and head down again, the sort of linear path. And then we'll be pressing the A or X button. See, it's clever how it works out there, isn't it? And basically, again, a lot throughout the game, you're going to see like these weird bits of light. Basically, they're just sort of energy lights that blonde Marianne needs in the alternate reality to be able to zap us through stuff. So we'll need it for elevators and fuse boxes that don't work, etc. So again, all you need to do is press the A button once. You know, you can press it twice or three times, but that doesn't necessarily mean you'll get a double or triple the energy. Worth a shot though, isn't it? So when you press A once, you can see Marianne's left arm, I believe, left. Her left arm is now lit up. That means that we've got the energy from that, which means we can now move on. So if you're going up to a door and her arm's not lit up, that means you just haven't soaked up the energy. So go to the fuse box, which is on the right-hand side. Press and hold the right trigger. Hold it for just a couple of seconds, let it go, and that will destroy the fuse box. So it does come in handy. It also gets us another achievement as well. So, now we can just move on. Ah, pain in the ass, she calls it. I wouldn't mind powers like that, mind. Although then again, you've probably got to sort of fight demons and have excruciating headaches and shit like that going on. So, actually, probably not worth it.
So there I was. Existing in two worlds, but never really living in either.
So at this little split here, it's left to continue with the story, but there is basically a dead deer on the right, which I just go and take a little look at. It literally does nothing for the story, but you know, chuck him in the oven, you know, wrap him up, chuck him in the oven, put some spices on him, I'm sure he'll taste pretty decent. But that literally has nothing to do with the story. That's just, I like meat. So we just move on again. Literally, there's only one linear path we go to until we are able to climb up, climb under a log, and then we are outside the Neva Hotel.
The aura in that place. I have seen others like it, but never this intense. It was like a landfill.
And here it is then. So we're going to be coming up to our first Echo collectible. Now again, these also you cannot see and you cannot track if you've collected these. So it's very important to go along and make sure you get the same ones I have. But straight in front of you, the car park is massive, but straight in front of you, sort of close to the entrance, there's going to be this payphone. Press X to interact with it. Press X again, and then what you have to do is hold LB to get your insight out, and there's going to be what looks like a little tear on every item. So have a look around for it, and there's going to be a little tear. There it is. Hold it just for a few seconds there until the flash happens. We get a couple of achievements here, but that is how the Echo counts, is when you've got this little bit of dialogue as well. So usually I'll just smash through the dialogue, but that is what you have to do to make sure the Echo counts. You can't just pick it up and look at the tear and then put it down. You've actually got to hold it for a few seconds and wait till the dialogue appears. So from there, head all the way to the left-hand side of the parking lot. There's going to be a unluckily abandoned car, which is every mechanic's dream because they love doing up old crappy rust bucket cars. They've done enough of mine in the past anyway. There it is eventually, and it's going to be postcard number 2, Honest Work. So take a look inside, eventually, when Marianne shuts her trap hole. There we go, thank you, honey. Have a look on the seat. Nice, I bet there's a few stains on there, not of the good kind either. And that will count for the second postcard. But we're actually going to be staying in the car. Have a look at the glove box to the left-hand side of the steering wheel. Pop open the boot. The trunk, the bloody bonnet, man. Yeah, there we go. So the bonnet, or the hood, if you're American, of course. That was me being silly there. I actually genuinely forgot what it was called. Ooh, nice. So, pick up the screwdriver. Obviously going to have a little tiny jump scare there. Scaring yourself, actually. And then Marianne's going to do her little jog. I don't know what jog that is, mind. That genuinely looks like you just crap your pants jog, but that's fine. Now we can actually go up towards the entrance and kick off the game properly. And so I know as a British person I pronounce things literally, but I will keep calling the Neva Hotel Neva, not newer, as to save potential confusion. Although saying Neva reminds me of Wally. Neva! Neva! Funny. Anyway, we've reached the hotel. We can't get in, but again, we do lock an achievement. And Thomas would have phoned us, but he's not there to greet us at the entrance like a douche hole. But that's fine, because we're going to find out what's going on. So again, what we can do, because it's video games, they don't like us to just go straight in. We've got to do a little bit of puzzle solving first. So we're going to head to the right, unlock us another achievement. Inner investigator. You may unlock this earlier or later on, depends on if you've been interacting with a few more objects and items throughout the world. So go inside, push this bin. Again, there's only one way she'll be pushing it, so push it until she gets all the way to the entrance again. We're going to climb up on that, and we're going to climb through the hotel window.
You better be worth it.
And when the cutscene is over, we can now get our second Echo, and it's directly on your left. We're going to be taking a look at the shoe. So again, press and hold the left bumper button, get your insight out, look for the tear, wait for the dialogue to happen, and Oh, the Neva Massacre. Now that sounds very Call of Duty, airport, Russian hotel type-esque kind of thing, doesn't it? So we begin now our third postcard now, so head up past these stairs, past the reception desk, and there's going to be a little sort of opening on the right here. We can't get in the gate at the back yet, so don't worry about that. The postcard is going to be on a table on its own, so again, make sure to pick up the promotion postcard before moving on. So that should be Echo 2 and postcard number 3. So, to progress with the story now, we actually have to interact with the gate at the back. Otherwise, the ring-a-ding-ding-ding doesn't start. So, again, watch it if you want. Always urge you to watch it. Some brilliant cutscenes in this game. But I'm always going to be, like I said, getting rid of cutscenes just to save time on the video, that's all. So, now head to the reception area and then interact with the ding-a-ling-a-ling bell. Well, I can see why they call her Sadness. She's only got one arm and she's trapped in hell. So head to the elevator at the back, press the X button to interact with it, and then go in and press either the either 1 or 2. I don't think it really makes a difference. The same outcome will happen. But yeah, in fact, if I had one arm and I was trapped in hell, I'd be called probably grumpy or pissed off rather than Sadness, but there we go. We just wait. And we wait, and obviously this is going to happen, so I don't think it matters if you press 1 or 2, same outcome is always going to happen. Now, this is another sort of time achievement that we can get. You press and hold B, and you sort of go into an out-of-body experience. Obviously the fuse box is messed up, we need to get that working. But to get the achievement, what you need to do is spend 10 minutes outside of your body. Now, you'd think you'd be able to just get it naturally through the game, but if you're very good at puzzles and if you follow along with the video, you can actually miss it. So, again, if you want to spend 10 minutes and wait until the achievement unlocks, again, of course, you are more than welcome to do that, but I will be showing you a place we'll get it a little bit later on anyway. So, as soon as you get down the stairs, head to the right, these sort of characters right, head up, and we'll be getting the eerie drawing to Friends Forever. Now again, like I mentioned earlier, these eerie drawings do not count towards an achievement, but I think all of them? I'm pretty sure I grabbed them all throughout the game anyway, just to tie in with the story nicely. But again, like I said, if you don't, if you end up missing one again, do not worry about the eerie drawings. So, press B to go back out, and then press B to go back in, and then go back out of your body, and we're going to be heading down those same stairs. Basically, we need to be sucking up some energy like we did a little bit earlier on with the other fuse box. So this time head sort of down on yourself rather than going up, which again it can be confusing because your first instinct is to go left, but then the camera changes, so you've got to go down. It's all a pissy mess, but here is the energy light we need, so suck it up, buttercup. Make sure that you are well lit on your left hand side arm there, and then you can just press B to go back into your body, press B to go back out, because of course Marianne in the real world can't get through. Use the spirit blast, hold the right trigger, and then that should be good. Now we can go up onto the second floor finally. Yeah, so I probably just over explained that a little bit, but of course there's going to be a lot of times throughout the game where Marianne in the real world can't get through something, so that's why we have to use our out-of-body experience, so Marianne in the alternate world can get through. So, head down the hallway. There's only one way again that we can go for a minute, and cutscene's going to happen.
What is this?
Right then, so what we need to do to progress the story and get our collectibles is go through this door on the right. But at the moment, we need an odd key to get through that, so we are not worrying about that. It's just a little bit up ahead, but what's going to happen now is, in the hellish world, the alternate reality is going to be a swarm of moths. So immediately, press your right bumper button, and that is going to summon our spirit shield, burn these moths to death, and basically doesn't kill us, which is nice. So head on up, and there's going to be a door on our left right here. Again, we'll be using press and holding the B button for the out-of-body experience. So now we can head through the door. And this is where we're going to be getting Echo 3. So we're going to be getting the odd key out of this room. By the way, I wish we had a summon experience shield like that for moths in the real world. That'd be friggin' nice. Ugh, creepy little crappy things. Who even invented that anyway? Anyway, so we're good now. So you can go back into your body. We've got the odd key. Marianne in the real world will keep that key as well. So now we can head through the door on the right. Ooh, don't go too far, because you can hear him all fluttering. Blech. Like winged rats. Bats. You all disgust me. Anyway, we can head through. Now, as you can see, Marianne done it in the real world, but it makes no difference. So, once here, go to the character's left. Sort of down this hallway as you enter the door. Enter the right open door at the end, and then directly in front of us is going to be a phone. That is going to be Echo number 3. Again, press and hold the left bumper for the inside, look for the tear, wait until it flashes and the dialogue happens. That's how it counts.
Yes, yes, a few days.
Ugh, that voice, I don't know why.
And now we're going to be grabbing our first out of 10 memory shards. Looks so like head down way. Through the hole in the Great. Floor. Ah, my ankles hurt. Oh, I got skinny crap ankles, so that's why. So this is going to happen. We're just going to head through the only open doorway there.
It feels
and if we have a look on the left-hand side, there's going to be an AC unit that we can interact with. There we go. There it is. So we'll interact with that. That's going to be the memory shard. Now, how you get these ones to count, interact with whatever item is there, and you have to mess around with the left stick and basically find the point of recollection. So it's all random, so it could be sort of on the left-hand side, right-hand side. But you sort of hold, you've got to hold it there as well until it flashes, sunflower. Some dialogue happens, and again, that is how
Mr.
you get a
Chuck
memory
Cop.
Shard to count.
Please.
But these do not get tracked
an
either.
Happy memory.
So hopefully, by following the video, you will get all 10 memory shards. But you, again, you cannot, they do not track, so be very wary of that. So go through the door on the right, only open door on the right, and then go behind us, and there is a mirror, a little bathroom. And inside the sink, underneath the mirror, have a look at the bottle of pills. Again, interact with that using the insight, and that would be Echo
Idiot.
4. There's also a collectible right next to it as well.
Why would he care
our first
any more than they
mentor diary.
This letter.
So when you're done all pilled up, make sure to grab the mentor's diary number 1 and apology right next to it. So be sure to grab them too before we move on. Now, these mentor's diary do track, so again, just keep making sure that you've got the same amount as me. So now we're going to be getting a third eerie drawing, so head down through the left-hand side on the door, come back on yourself as well, and there's going to be an eerie drawing just underneath all the pile of bones and rubble and things there. Again, eerie drawings don't count for an achievement, but we're going to be grabbing them anyway. So head back to sort of where we came. Into the main area and then head outside on the left, right there. And you sort of go right here. We'll be using our little blonde friend on the right hand side in the alternate reality. Now you see what we buy right now? That's actually skin. Delicious, huh? So I thought we were in a different country for a second there, because some countries like to serve up skin, don't they? But we're just gonna slowly go across the ledge. Heading through the only doorway then. That is a memory shard we'll be coming to a little bit later on. Head sort of towards the back, have a look through this door, and then what you actually need to do here is look down. And then jump scares going to happen. that threw me off guard, really. I actually, I almost cracked my pants, genuinely, now. So, good jump scare. That is what you call a jump scare. See, something that you don't expect. Empty the bloodbath. Use your insight, and then you'll be able to get the razor blade that way. That, of course, unlocks us the Edge of Sanity achievement for acquiring the razor. And we're going to keep that for a good portion of the game. So we can just head back into our body now. And now what we can use is the razor on said skin path. So slice it down. So you've got, again, do it yourself. Press down on the left trigger. And just, we'll hear all the delicious skin flapping about and stuff like a big saggy veg. So, now that bit's over, we can actually enter this room. So that's what we're going to do. Enter it, and then what you need to do is sort of head left into the next area. Now, there's going to be a sunflower, but we're going to ignore that for now. That's what progresses the story a little bit. So ignore the sunflower, go behind it, and then interact with this bowl. And again, like we just did, make sure to get the point of recollection with your left stick. Hold it until the dialogue happens, and that is how you count the memory shard. Nothing wrong with a bit of old guy or nurse action there. So we're going to be getting Echo 5 now, so head back into the sort of main area of the room, go down and then to the right into this bathroom, and it is the mirror that we need to interact with. So again, press it, left bumper, insight, and that is Echo number 5.
To cut your...
There have been times when I was too afraid forever.
Now we can go ahead and grab the sunflower. Now I did spend around 3 or 4 minutes just using the out-of-body experience just to bump up the achievement numbers a little bit there. But like I said, now if you don't want to do that, of course, we'll just grab the dried up sunflower and then we can go back to the main area, which is sort of out and of course to the left when we get outside. Now we can interact with the vase directly in front of us, put in the dried up sunflower, which by the way kind of looks like my weenus, looks sad and dried up, unused. Anyway, that's for a totally different video, or maybe I'll just keep that to myself next time. So when you put the dried up sunflower in the vase, now we can press A to get the bit of energy which hell Marianne needs. Now go out into the hallway, press the right bumper to summon your spirit shield, and get through those sons of little biatches, and unlock an achievement as we do so. So this is yet another linear path. All we're doing is just heading up the stairs. We're going to be moving the sort of closed hamper thing out of the way of the door, going through it, and then we'll be using our summon shield again to get through the moths for a second time.
Something sharp.
So after we get through what is literally my idea of hell, winged crappy things in your face, make sure to just keep going straight. There is a door on the left that we can go through, but to get this eerie drawing, you have to get this one first before you head through, otherwise the door will lock and you can't get it. So use your out-of-body experience, go forward just a little bit, pick up the lonely eerie drawing, and then that should be good. Again, if you do miss that one, you know, don't worry about it at all. It's not worth an achievement, and I've said it a few times, but just in case. Just in case you think, oh my god, you son of a bitch. Anyway, now we can head through the door, and we're going to be getting our first troubled man's note, called A Peaceful Place. And basically, where we're standing there is directly in front of us in just a little box. So we just pick it up. That is that. These ones, again, also track, so we get an achievement for that. And these ones track as well, which makes it easier to know if you are on the same path as me. This is just a document, literally makes no difference. But for interacting with 50 objects in a single playthrough, I get that achievement. So again, you might get it a little bit before or a little bit after me, depending on if you've been searching through thoroughly the rooms. So you interact with the door, and then a cutscene is going to happen. Thomas Rekovich. Definitely sounds Call of Duty Russian airport style kind of name, that, doesn't it? No offense, I'm just joking. I like that name. So what we can do, there is an eerie drawing in this room as well, but we'll be getting the Trouble Man's notes first, because to be honest, I forgot about the eerie drawing until a little bit later on. So in the room right here, interact with the desk, and on the right hand side of this desk, that is where the to-do list, Trouble Man's notes 2, is. Don't turn off that damn alarm clock. Comes in handy, that is, when you're sleeping late. So what we need to do, look directly below you, and there's going to be a little flashlight. There it is. So we'll just keep that on us. Again, I don't know where she's sticking it all, but that's fine. But we've got a small key now. I know where she's sticking that. We'll be sticking that right in the clock, as that's the only place it can go. I don't know what you were thinking of, but there it is. So go to the grandfather clock. Stick the small key inside. Dry, or if you want to lube him up, that's fine. Completely up to you. And so this is basically just a little puzzle. So interact with the clock, and we're going to start shifting time sort of backwards. And what we can see on the right-hand side of the screen there is different parts of what Thomas was up to. Now this will come in handy as we need to get into a secret room. And as we go through about 7 o'clock, we'll see the secret room open up. There it is. And then if we go to about 5 to 5... we'll see Thomas entering, or sort of, you know, his shadow or whatever, entering it. But how we actually need to, we can actually go through now, but we need to go to 4 o'clock first, and then go back out. We need to actually absorb some of that energy with Hell Marianne right there. So absorb some of that. Again, doing it twice makes no difference, but makes you feel double more powerful, doesn't it? And then we can go back to 5 to 5 until the door opens up, or 5 o'clock, whatever. And then we can actually enter ourselves. Press and hold B to get out of body experience. And there is a fuse box on the back wall. Again, press and holding the right trigger for a couple of seconds. Release that schniz, and that will open up the door lovely for us. So real world Marianne can now get through. But just before we head on through, if you want to be grabbing the 5th eerie drawing, it's in the previous room where we entered before. And as you can see, in Hell Marianne, it is sort of just on the floor next to the box where we found the first Trouble Man's notes. So I forgot to pick that one up earlier on, so apologies about that. But now we're going to be bumper-bumper-bum heading through the secret door. So use your insight, and you can see an obvious-looking switch just behind a photograph. I mean, it's not really hidden that well. I mean, you could have just done that yourself. But, obviously, it's never that obvious, is it? So now we are in this room, we are locked, and now we're basically going to die, right? Wrong! Syphilis, herpes, STDs! Oh, damn it! Wrong video again. So, head to the middle of the room. That is where the Trouble Man's Notes 3 is. But we are needing to get another photo. This, again, is story-related, so we won't be missing this one. But have a look on the chair. First, we'll be grabbing the fixer. It's not as easy as the photo one with Jack. It's a bit all over the place. But again, head into the middle of the room. Eventually, there we go. On the floor, you will see the Trouble Man's Notes 3 getting stronger. And now we actually have to grab all the items we need to carry on. So have a look at the box on the floor. On the left there, you'll see a metal tray. That comes in handy for hitting demons with. Just joking. But on the bookshelf as well, just a bit further to the right, we are going to find the multi-grade. So that should be 2 bottles out of 3 we need. And the third one is actually in the sink, right all next to all the where the photo pieces and developing pieces are. So if you head back to the sort of middle of the room, on the left-hand side is the sink. You'll have to back out of this bit. It can be quite finicky sometimes if Marianne sort of moves on her own. You interact sometimes with the wrong thing. But there we go. So that's the metal tray. That's all the 3 bits of liquid that we need. So now we can interact with the bit of photo. So again, as you can see, for the light, it's 5 seconds. Just like the one earlier on, 5 seconds for the light, 3 seconds for literally everything else. So obviously grab a piece of photo paper. To actually get things rolling, we need to interact with the light on the backhand wall, just to the right of this board right here. So, there we go. 3 liquids to develop the photo. We've done it earlier, it's easy enough, but we just got a little bit more work to do in it. So, first of all, put your metal tray down. We ain't going to be bashing no demon ass with that. And then use the photo paper once again on the light. Turn it on and then count to 5 seconds and then interact with the photo paper again. So I'm going to be putting the liquids in the easiest order now. So basically on the very left hand side, we're going to be putting the multigrade down. So put the multigrade down first. Then for the middle one, use the stopper or the stop. And then for the right side, use the fixer. You don't have to, you can do it in literally any order, but I just found it a lot easier to do it that way so you're not accidentally getting confused. So put the illuminated photo in the multigrade first, 3 seconds of course, whip that out, then use it in the stop for 3 seconds, then the fixer for 3 seconds. And that will get us a cutscene. And then we're going to be chased by the monster for the first time. Now, a lot of people have gotten confused whether the Phantom achievement, that's for not getting seen at all by the Maw, the couple of times that we have to stealth through him, whether you can or cannot get caught in this first chase scene. The simple answer is, though, you can. I got caught, and I'll keep it on screen here. So immediately after this cutscene, press down on the D-pad, and that is where we have to go. The camera will eventually turn around for us. But I will show you right here, because I was being a bit of an idiot myself, to be honest. So, oh, it all ends in me, does it? This guy's at a gay orgy party, isn't he? But anyway, so this is where I show you then. I die right here. So you can get caught at this chase scene and still get the Phantom achievement later on. It's the stealth sections that we need to not be seen at all. But again, we'll come back to that a little bit later on. So immediately, like I said, as the cutscene starts, press down on the D-pad to start running. The camera will turn around, and then it's literally just a case of following the linear path left and right as things block our way.
Oh, God.
Don't leave me here. Alone.
Make it.
Let me draw you off.
Oh, God! No!
Go on! You'll be just fine. You won't be home ever again! Everybody and everything, it all ends in me!
So, he doesn't like light. Of course they don't. Monsters don't like light. That's just how it goes in every video game. So, what we need to do then. This, I believe, does count in terms of you cannot get seen at all. So if the monster sees you and he chases you, that's going to void the achievement. So if he sees you, it's definitely best to reload your save. If he catches you, do not press continue. If he catches you, press start and then go to reload your save. Very, very important. Apparently a lot of people have not unlocked the achievement by just pressing continue after being caught. So just keep that one in mind there. So the more scary looking thing, by the way, is actually voiced by Troy Baker. So from Bioshock Infinite, The Last of Us, Batman Arkham Knight, excellent voice actor. Proper legend. So you can just carry on sneaking here for now. He's not going to come back down. Eventually he's going to do his whole moth trick and fly away in moths. Honestly, he voiced the mob absolutely brilliantly. Absolutely love his voice. And again, the camera angle is going to slightly change here.
You're just like the others.
You don't care.
Clever little skin suit.
It is just a case of, as soon as he starts walking away, then you can start sneaking behind him. Of course, try and stay behind these boxes on the right-hand side if you can. But he is basically just going to keep walking up and then turn left and come back down the other side of the boxes. So just stay right behind these boxes on our right until he turns left. There we go. And now we are basically home free. Just head towards the light. We need to absorb that energy and then get through some moths, pressing the right bumper button.
I have spent my whole life looking beyond the edges of our reality.
So remember, if you actually get caught and he starts chasing you, just completely reload your save. Otherwise, it'll just void the achievement if you carry on. So once we are out of there then, we've escaped the monster, we've got the achievement. You need to head towards the reception and interact with the radio. This is an automatic bit. Sadness is going to be talking to us.
Happy. You're... okay.
Sadness? Is that you? Are you okay? What was that thing? Hello?
Find! Richard!
Richard? No, Sadness. The man I'm looking for is named Thomas. Who's Richard?
The day room.
Day room?
So this is another easy bit. We're just following the flickering lights for now. As soon as you get close, the next flickering light goes on, etc, etc. By the way, it all ends in me. I really want someone to shout that at the point of climax when they are making the proverbial love. I would pee myself laughing if that would ever happen. Anyway, so here we are then at the day room. It is locked, so we're going to go up these little bits of steps on the right, come back towards yourself, and there is going to be the troubled man's note, Fever Dreams 4 on the floor. Sorry, I can just imagine it now. Oh yes, oh yes, it all ends in me. I would die laughing. Anyway, you could actually interact with the day room door to find out that it's locked, and the flickering will then stop. Then we can actually move on a little bit. So then, there are three more times we've got to sneak past the demon. Two are very, very easy. One can be potentially a little bit tricky, but it's not. Genuinely, it is not too bad at all. So head underneath all this rubble. We're going to sort of end up in this little pool room now. At least
sadness was still with me, in a way.
And what we're going to do is head around the other side. Sadly, this pool isn't filled. I mean, come on, we could have at least gone for a little cheeky dip. Although, there is the maw after us and everything, so you'd probably shiten yourself before that happens. So head towards the shallow part of the pool, and we can just see a little button there that we can get down with. So press the Y button to get down. Across the opposite end is a militia board, or the banister, or banner, or whatever people call it in different countries. Then use insight on the light to get echo number 6.
Just wanted to go. You can see how you're...
Some things don't just go away.
Alrighty then, so climb out of the pool, and we're going to be getting echo number 7. And it's the same sort of militia barrier. So once again, use insight, look for the tear, job the good.
The nurse, she did it. She killed them. Is that really what you want us to put on record?
It's what I...
The nurse.
So after that, head to the right through the only open door. And as you can see, directly in front of you, there's going to be a little hole in the wall. We're just going to climb through that. We'll interact with the other thing a little bit later on. But head to the left-hand side, just slightly, ever so slightly. You can see this pile of clothes on the floor. Again, interact with it with insight. Echo number 8. Don't know why you want to touch those dirty, bloody-looking, blood clot, jizz-stained, period-blooded-up pants. But there we go, that's fine. So, directly behind you, before going through the door, make sure to grab postcard number 4 in this box. Someday... And then we can head through the door. So as we head up, go through the door and then again just go sort of directly behind you, the sort of character's right. And there's going to be the Trouble Man's Notes number 5, good old Frankie Dank. So after that, what we can do is just head on up, and we're going to be staying in this sort of area for about the next half hour or so of the game. These are the double doors we need to get through, but they are locked, so we need to go through this whole thing to get a pair of bolt cutters. Ah, come on, Marianne, you don't look that bad. I know plenty of weirdos who would still search you up on Pornhub. You look fine. So head all the way to the back where these... again, bit of rubbles is, and that is where the bolt cutters are. I'm pretty sure in real life you could just climb up and then sort of stretch your arm out and grab them, but it's not how it works in video games, as is the norm. So we're going to head back, have a look in the mirror again, and now you can see sadness and hell Marianne there. Again, sadness looking really angry because she's had her arm torn off, which is just, you know, not the best, is it? But basically, what she's done now is got the spirit trail for us to follow, which, you can see using the left bumper with your insight. Now we can go in the door behind us, just opposite the mirror, and then, again, sort of head to the character's left, I think, sort of behind, make sure to get echo number 9. I'm pretty sure this is where all these little butterflies, the spirit trails, lead to anyway, but there it is. So head to the opposite way now, and we're basically back in the pool room, so we're going to jump down. Once again, this time we can jump down this side of the pool now, so again, press Y to jump down. And if you go into the middle of the pool, there is going to be a new item for us to interact with, and that is echo number 10, this little puppy dog.
Ready or not?
That voice.
So head back now to where you just were. Now there's two places we can get up on the pool. It's not this side, but it is the side that we just jumped down from a little bit earlier on. So apologies about that. So make sure to climb up the sort of left side of these two button prompts right here, and there's going to be another echo for us to interact with, this little toady bow. So now we're going to be grabbing Echo 12, and that is in the same room just as we entered earlier on, just at the back of this pool room. And if you're wondering why we're having to do it in an order like this and going around again instead of just collecting them all at once, this is just how the game has basically done it. So it's not us going around in circles for no reason. This is how the game wants us to do it. So before going through the hole in the wall, push this big shower basket thing out of the way, and there's going to be Echo 12 on the floor. This little toe tank.
Shh, here she comes. Guys? I really don't...
Shut the heck up, guys!
Oh, kids can be such app.
So once that is done then, we're going to be grabbing a new collectible type now. Other is what it's called. So we head through the hole in the wall, but this does not relevate itself to any achievements again. So this is purely just based for story, as I know a lot of people like these sort of backstory and a lot of things. So head all the way to the left, open up the lockers, the only one that you can interact with. And then if you have a look at the top, that is where you will get the torn illustration. And again, so there's only three of these to find, but they are not linked or tied to any achievements, so don't worry if you do end up missing them. Grab the white cat figurine at the bottom. Basically, that is going to help us get through the mirror onto the other side. So we'll be doing that quite a lot, using mirrors to get through to the other side, and vice versa. So now, nothing else to do in here. We're going to be going back upstairs and then back to the mirror again to check ourselves out, because, hey, Marianne, you look like shit. Now, oh, that's harsh.
Here. I felt a slight tug in my pocket. I could tell there was more to that figurine than just carved wood. I can feel it calling out to me. What the hell is this place?
So there we go then. Now we have made it to the other side, but we don't know how to get back. We basically need to get another cat figurine in this world to be able to get back. So the way we do that is, as we can see here, we need to basically get rid of this trapped soul, let his spirit free, yada yada yada, all the hippie stuff, but it's actually going to help us out to get out of this hellhole. So he needs a mask. We basically need to find this guy's mask, or this little boy's mask. And as you're going along, you will sort of hear parts of how he got bullied and had his spirit and everything torn down. And that's why they're stuck here, because they had their spirit torn down so much, they just got completely fudged up, which is, it's a very big shame. So there's a little door on the right that we can head into. And basically there's a spirit well in here, so we can suck up some energy. Again, doing it twice or three times just makes you feel that triple more powerful, doesn't it? And there's nothing wrong with that. So head to the opposite side now, and we need to be getting our skinny, flappy bit of flapping and flappuses out. So whip your razor blade out at the top, and then, oh, cut your skin off in half. Ugh. Make them flappy boys flap. So you can actually get through. Eventually we're going to be able to make it. And as you can see, the reason we got the spirit well, you can see those winged beasts directly behind it. So as soon as we flap out the flatnesses, press the right bumper and then head on in. Burn you little... Well, yeah, she got a point. They are little bangs. Are they not? So as soon as it's done, you've got to burn them all. Wait until they all piddle off. And this is where the young boy's mask is. So interact with it using the A button. And to be honest, calling your son Bernard, that probably didn't help his cause either. Sorry, just joking, everyone with the name Bernard. I love you guys. Anyway, so now we can head back to the boy with the mask, which is just sort of down and all the way down. But be prepared to be chased by the Maw. As soon as we pick up the cat figurine, which is behind him, the Maw will chase us. So we need to head down and go into the right, where we found the spirit well, as there is a mirror in there. So, thank you. Anything for you, Bernard. I bloody love you. Pick up the black cat, and then literally, we're going to be needing to press down on the D-pad as soon as we escape. So, now, we're out of it. So, go. Head straight down, and then head into the right side door, and then past the spirit well, there is a mirror that we can exit through. But now, basically what the Maw's going to be doing now, he's coming with us. And as soon as you exit here, this is where the second part is going to be. So run down, and we're going to be hiding behind these sort of gymnastic kind of things. But press the start button, go to gameplay, and now go down to insight mode and hold breath mode. Put them both to toggle instead of hold, and this will help you massively. So put them on to toggle, go back out, and then press obviously left to sneak, pressing the left button to sneak, and then press the right button in once to hold your breath. This just helps massively. And also, if you again obviously press the left bumper, which is your insight, you can just see a little outline of where he is, and the little arrows on screen as to where he is. Obviously, red means he's close, yellow means he's getting further away, and white means he's basically gone. So again, just a couple of things there to keep in mind, but that is the second time that we need to be not seen by him. Remember, if you are seen by him for any point, and he starts chasing you, or he catches you, reload your save, do not continue, just reload your save. So now he's gone, we can just go into the opposite room now, and there's going to be a phone on the wall. Interact with that for Echo 13.
New details have emerged. The situation, no time to explain.
Very meticulous of you, comrade.
So once we are done with that echo, head to the mirror just next to it, go through to the other side, and before heading through the open door, have a look at the, well, sort of the forefront of the screen for an eerie drawing number 6, that is Bad Nurse. Now, what we have to do here is basically help two extremely poor, unfortunate souls who are stuck together. The left path is the male, and the right path, the left one is the male and the right one is the female. So we have to basically do each of those anyway, so it really doesn't matter. We have to help both of these out anyway to get to the bolt cutters. But we are going to be helping out the male first. So head through the left-hand side door. And then if you go up, rather than going up the stairs, sort of up straight on the screen, that is where we're going to get eerie drawing number 7, Dark. And then basically it's up the stairs and it's a linear path until we get through to a mirror. But now what I had done, and I will explain this quickly because there'll be a few edits a little bit later on which may potentially confuse you. So I started off obviously as we're doing now, helping out the male, so doing all the left side stuff. But the little puzzle at the end, for some reason I left, I went and helped the female. By the way, so if you just go to the right-hand side here, you can grab the mask, and then we can go through the mirror. So I'd left the male puzzle at the end, went and done the female one, went all the way back, came all the way back then just to do the last male puzzle, and then I cracked on with it. But of course, that took roughly about 6 or 7 minutes, and it was just pointless to do it that way. So obviously what I'm going to show you is how to completely help the male on this side. By the way, as we get through the mirror, stick with this left-hand side wall, and there's going to be a phone that we can interact with, which is Echo number 14. So as I said, I also get the Psychic Sleuth for inspecting 100 objects in a single playthrough. Again for you, might be a little bit longer, might be a little bit less, depending on what you've been doing yourself. So yeah, so as I've said, the edits in a little bit can be confusing, but I will explain. So just follow along with what I'm doing anyway, and you will be absolutely fine. So, head up past these chairs, but these chairs are going to come in handy for us as the Maw comes through this little hallway. But head up to the back, go to the left-hand side open door, around these tables for now, and then down to the other side is another ashtray where they will where we will find Echo number 15. And what's funny is, I'm sure they've got they've got Boris Johnson, the UK's Prime Minister, douchebag, if you will. He's a sexist pig, late as usual. That's just Boris Johnson down to a friggin' T. Down to a T. So anyway, to complete this little puzzle, it's very, very easy. Have a look at the piece of paper on the opposite end, and you'll see number 9 there, Boris Ziglugulug. I can't actually tell the writing, but we're going to call him Boris Johnson anyway. And what we have to do now is actually inspect the number 9 chair, which is on the left-hand side, and it's the last one just before we get into the ashtray. So what we need to do then is look who was opposite Boris, which, if you go around the other side and have a look, number 04. Have a look at the list, and it is Nicholas. So that is the name. We need to get these names to be able to free the spirits, by the way. So have a look at the paper again, and then interact with that. But as soon as we do that, the more will appear. So as soon as we're out of it, head out into the hallway, and then stick, hug the right-hand side wall. Very important to hug that right-hand side wall. Press the left stick to sneak and the right stick in to stop breathing, and just hide behind these chairs for the moment. For some reason, even though it's flickering, the more will just walk straight past us. Again, use your insight to have a look at the arrows, and then as soon as he walks past, just keep sneaking down, go into the right-hand side room, and then head up back towards the mirror and get out of there. Don't run. Literally, do not run. Because if you run, he will hear you, and that will void the achievement. I think a lot of people did make that mistake. And also, a lot of people were seemingly saying, as soon as you finish that puzzle, go back into the conference room and hide behind the table at the bottom, next to the ashtray. But a lot of people have said they didn't unlock the achievement that way. So it's definitely worth going out into the hallway, hiding behind the chair, and doing it that way. That is how you will unlock the achievement, or it's how it did unlock for me anyway. So again, apologies if there was a bit of an over-explanation with that then. Guys, I just don't want things to be confusing and you to accidentally miss something or end up missing an achievement for whatever reason. So now we can give Nicholas his mask. Now, of course, on your screen, you will still have the female there, but for some reason, I went and done the female first and then done the male for whatever reason. And again, this little edit, we're still in that same area, but now we're going into the right side room and we are going through the mirror. So again, apologies if that was a little bit confusing there, guys, but we've basically helped out the male. Now we're going back to the right to help out the female. So when we're out of the mirror, have a look by the bin, sort of close to where the echo was, and we'll find the examination room key. Now we can go into the door right next to the mirror, which was previously lock mode. When we head through, instead of going straight down, head to the left, and that is where we will find postcard 5, a scenic view. Ooh! Breathe. But we do not have much time for breathing, as we're going to be getting the 4th out of 4 sneaking past the moor type of achievement coming up soon. And this is not as easy as the previous two, unfortunately, but it's still not too bad. So we're just going to head through the mirror right here. Again, there's only one linear path that we can go through. So it's sort of down and then around until we get to the next side of the mirror. And so here we go then. So go through the room and make sure to crouch immediately. Now, The way the Moor is walking, it could be random for you, so it could be going the other way for you. So just make sure to figure out where he is walking. As soon as he goes to the other side of the boxes, then just keep going straight. And then basically what we're going to be going is underneath these sort of bookcases here. Even if he... But just keep going. Because even if he's behind you, he cannot see you there. So don't worry about that. Now this bit, I almost get caught. And we'll see how badly I almost get caught now. So, definitely worth waiting here until he goes to the right side of the screen. I start moving. And as you can see, I literally almost get caught. But he hasn't seen me because nothing happened. So he's just carrying on walking. It's a bit tricky because it's much more darker. So you just have to keep following where the arrows are and see sort of which pattern and which way he's walking to be able to go round the boxes like I did or underneath them like I did. And as you can see there, he did actually have a look for me as he heard a little noise. But because he didn't actually see me and start chasing me, that is fine. So if he has a look over the boxes for you, don't panic. You should be fine. But again, like I said, if he did catch you, remember to press the start button and then press the reload save button rather than continue. So we won't get the achievement yet. It won't unlock for until a little bit later on. But we're going to head past the boxes into this room. And on this middle table on its own is Echo number 16. So hopefully then, all of those little hints and tips that I gave you with the Phantom helped out big time, and that we'll unlock that. We unlock that after we get through the locked double doors with the bolt cutters later on. So again, don't panic if you haven't unlocked it yet. So when we're done here, just interact with the mirror to get through to the other side, obviously. And then literally it's another case of just nipping to the left a bit and getting through this mirror. And we've got just a few things to do. Echo 17, 18, 19, and 20. Basically, it's just at the foot of the bed. That is the little piece of paper that we need to be interacting with. There are two names on there. Obviously, we can't get it from there. But for some reason, I got lost because I am stupid. Well, I'm not. It's just hard to see sometimes. So, partial numbers. That's what we need by the foot of the bed. And then on the left side of the bed is an open notebook. Very self-explanatory. Actually, in the end, it's just a case of kind of not being like me and actually finding it. Ah, there we go. See, we get there eventually. So all you got to do then, interact, put the torn notebook page in, and basically there are four echoes that we need to interact with. There we go. So there are the four button prompts. Make sure before we leave that you interact with every single one of them to get Echo 17, 18, 19, and 20.
Are they asleep? Thanks. I'll see.
Not exactly a hot.
Yes, I'm doing what? Well, what about my heart? Don't call me Victoria.
Victoria? That was a.
Hello? Yes, there was a man here. Yet what? That was.
Well?
Oh my god, Ellie! No, I'm really happy to hear from you. You did? Eugene.
Ellie. She was so... Tori. It's you.
So, we've got the name now. Victoria. Ah, what we need to do then, as soon as we stop yammering on for just a second... That's what you sound like in this part, Marianne. Yep, so go through the mirror, head to the left, and this is where we will see Victoria's mask. So her soul was pretty brutally brought down, which is... Well, it's sad. Nobody deserves that, except for paedophiles and murderers and such. But she didn't seem like a pedo or a murderer, so... You know... Life is one big bitch. But we're going to be heading back through the mirror anyway. And now, basically what we can do is finish here. So we can actually head out of the room. This door was previously locked before, so obviously we couldn't go through there. And then head through the next mirror and basically just head back down to be able to give Vicky her mask so her spirit cannot be free, if I mean. Not very good at ye old English talk.
I'm not gonna lie. It felt good, putting that curse of mine to good use. Moments like that used to keep me going. Now, I'm not sure anymore.
So, once we're here, remember, you would have already done the male side, so he won't be on screen for you. So, just give the mask of the woman to Tori, and the next screen you will be able to see is this one. So, once they've both done, the whatever the hell they were being held onto will be finished, and the bolt cutters will be behind. But we obviously can't pick him up yet, because we're in hell, or alternate reality, world. Real world. I don't know, but we can't pick them up anyway, so you need to just head through the obviously previously locked door, and we're going to head through to the mirror, and we're going to immediately going to be grabbing another collectible. So when we're through the mirror, have a look on the desk behind you and grab the other note collectible, a quiet girl, a quiet girl. There we go. A couple of things that we... I think there's two more things we need to be grabbing. Head into the next room. Finally grab the bolt cutters. Jesus. Now, that was a lot of work for a couple of bolt cutters, but they're going to come in mighty handy in quite a lot of times. So, come into the next room, and there's going to be a hole on the right-hand side wall that we can go through. And then, before moving on, interact with this wheelchair right in the middle of the room. Take a look if you want, but it's all sort of been, you know, bloodied and period stained and stuff, so I wouldn't advise it. Interact with it. That's Echo 21. And there is the other collectible right here. Have a look on the desk. There's a scalpel on top and the empty eyes note at the bottom. Again, not tied to any achievements or anything, but if you're interested in the story, well... it starts getting a little more weird, as if things are not weird anyway. But that is finally done for this bit then. Now your heart's probably going, please, please, please let me unlock that Phantom achievement, because mine was. I genuinely thought I screwed it up. So we're going to head down, and the door is here somewhere, I promise. There it is. So get your bolt cutters up. You need to press the left and right trigger at the same time a couple of times, and as soon as you step through the door, the achievement should unlock. I was still going, please, 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 please. Yes! So I was happy. But hopefully, you would have got that as well. So apologies, though, if it has not. But we're going to head down the stairs now. So just remember, that is where you should unlock the Phantom achievement. If not, sadly, you may have to go... you will have to go through the game again. So use the bolt cutters on these doors now. Ha, that's very funny, Marianne. Bolt cutters.
Or a movie star. Like, in a movie you don't use your real name for. Yeah.
We know what you mean, Marianne Snatchbag. We know your porn name. Yeah, dirty git. Anyway, there's only one way to go now. Out of the pool room, we don't need to be going there anymore. So a couple of achievements going to unpop for me right here. Again, this is one that you may get a little bit earlier or a little bit later on, so don't worry about that if you haven't run 2 kilometers yet. Now, when we get back to the day room, stop! Do not open up and go through the day room just yet. Do not. We need to be getting a note which was previously inaccessible, which is now accessible, and you will not be able to get it if you just go through straight through the day room. So... it's basically back in the main lobby area with the receptionist and the elevators, etc. And remember that big locked gate at the very end? This time it is more... we can bolt cut our way through it now. So go through all the way to the very end. Use the bolt cutters again, left trigger and right trigger at the same time a few times. I also get the insightful achievement right here, so whether you've been using insight, the left bumper, again, you may get that a little bit later, or you may have already unlocked it. But at the back of this room is Trouble Man's Note 6, Dust and Death. So remember, when you get the bolt cutters, before going through the day room, make sure to grab this collectible first, otherwise you're going to have to go through the entire game again, and I don't want you to have to do that. The despair would be unbelievable. But once we do have that collectible, we can now finally go through the day room. And we don't have any of these more sneaking stealth sections. There's only one a lot later on, and that's extremely easy. But hopefully you would have got the Phantom achievement, that collectible, and now we can safely move on. Hooray!
All right, here we go.
Right then, so also what I'm going to be doing now is unlocking the achievement for spending 10 minutes outside of your body. I'm going to do that right here because, like I said, I haven't used it that much throughout the game, even though I've spent a couple of minutes here and there, but I haven't used it in terms of puzzles and things. So it's definitely worth, again, you can do it a little bit later on if you want, but if you just want to get it out of the way, it's generally worth just pressing the B button, waiting for around probably less than 10 minutes or so now, as we've used it quite a few times in the game. Just get it out of the way now, so that's something else that you don't have to worry about. So definitely worth just getting it now. But there are, again, a couple of times that we use it later on in the game. So just make sure to get it then before you end it. But once we are here, there are a lot of collectibles. We're going to be doing more collectible hunting than actual gameplay hunting. So get out your razor blade and cut the skin. It kind of looks like the skin from your balls, doesn't it? You slice it open in two balls. Blah! Can't even finish that sentence. Cut open the skin anyway. Just cut open the skin. For the love of God. And when the way is free, immediately head to the left. Richard. And then there is a drawing just on this wall here of a horse. So use your insight. And that's Echo number 22.
Gather round, children. I want you to meet Lilia.
Why can't I play with...
Friends.
And when this Echo is done, make sure to grab the Mentor's Diary number 2 right next to it, Throwing Away Greatness. That's like the entirety of my life. Yeah. Anyway, once we're done here then, if you sort of head to the right-hand side and go up a little bit, you can see a couch. That is going to have Mentor's Diary 3, A Very Special Boy. Now, this was written about me. But sadly, it's not the special that I'm actually thinking of. But now, if you sort of head down towards the screen, you're going to see this table. And then, just to the left side of the table, you can see this IV bag with all piss and stuff in it. But we're going to interact with that. Again, make sure to get the Memory of Recollection until the dialogue appears, and that should be Memory Shard number 3.
Would be better off in a... What about his fa...
Richard, doesn't it?
We were close once, you know. All right.
Hollow like a puppet.
So now if we head to the right side of this table, the camera's going to change again, and Mentor's Diary number 4 is going to be on a chair. Sort of just directly in front of us there, so make sure to pick a Well of Inspiration up. That was also not written about me. It was actually written about those influencers in Dubai with their titties and bows out. Thank you for inspiring me, you bunch of aged up losers. Anyway, let's get Mentor's Diary number 5 anyway. So if we just head up towards the door and to the left, if you look directly in front of us, there's going to be an open door. And then through this open door, after we have a little conversation with ourselves, the diary is just on the right-hand side of the door on the table right there. Guilt, humiliation, and rage. Sounds like my first intercourse session, that. Yeah, not a good time. Anyway, enough about me now. So make sure to grab that Mentor's Diary number 5. And then we've got a little puzzle to do which involves this globe. We can't actually complete it yet, so head back out and then sort of go down just a touch. And as you can see on this chair, this isn't a collectible, but this is required for story progression. It's a part of a music sheet, so make sure to grab that first. And then what we can do is actually head back down and then go to the right where we found Mentor's diary number 4. There it is. So just keep going a little bit further down and we're going to find the second music sheet, and it's going to be on one of these desks. There it is, just there. So make sure to grab that. So that'll be 2 out of 3. You can combine them now if you want, or you can do it a bit later on. Makes no difference for the moment. So we're going to be going through a door that only Hell Marianne can get through now. So if you just head around this table, sorry, I sort of got my track, my bearings a bit lost there. But go around that table and then it's the locked door right there. You can literally go straight up from where we got that music sheet, but I went the long way for some reason. So go outside of your body, only Hell Marianne can get in, and then pick up this, the equator it's called, and that is for the bit of globe. So we're going to be coming back in this room a little bit later on with both the characters, but for now we can just head back into our body and then head towards the left, past the table, past the double doors, and through the only open door. Interact now with the globe and then go ahead and put the equator on it. Now this puzzle, it's not too difficult really, but basically we need to be making a face. So the two holes are the eyes. Obviously the one that looks like a mouth will go on the bottom, so the eyes at the top, nose in the middle, mouth at the bottom. So I just keep interacting with the eyes until it gets all the way at the top, then I just interact with the mouth at the bottom until the two combine, and then they all sort of combine. You just it's really not too difficult. You will get there eventually in the end. May take just a few minutes potentially, but it's not too difficult at all. Now what this can do, we can actually move the vines that are blocking Hell Marianne's way now. So use the left stick to interact with it. Go left or right. Go left just a little bit if you want to. We are going to be getting eerie drawing 8, which is taken away, and I can just about interact with it there. So that is what I can grab. Again, you don't have to, you can just carry on with it, because what we'll be doing is getting the vines right out of the way so we can go through the door there, the exit. And then what we're going to be doing is actually coming up to Memory Shard 4. Now this was, of course, a previously inaccessible room. Now we can get in. Now, the Memory Shard is actually on the desk, but what I've actually done is just interact with the piano. This is a little puzzle that we'll be coming to a little bit later on, but for now you don't have to do anything. You can't absorb the spirit well because something's missing, which is said piano. So, like I said, go onto the desk on the right, interact with that, the key, and then again use the point of recollection to put it all together and then listen to the dialogue.
It reminds me of my...
But...
You're a very secure...
Her voice.
And when we've done Memory Shard number 4 there, go to the right and grab the key. That's sort of to the teacher's room. We'll begin echo number 23, so go ahead. Get rid of this bit of ball, little loose ball sack skin right here first. Then we can simply go towards the table, the sort of middle of the room. To the right of that is the door that we could not previously access. So that's good, now we've got the key for it. We can go in again, a couple of collectibles in this room that we're going to grab as well. So as we enter, directly in front of you on the desk or on the table is like a pencil case looking kind of thing. So find the tear and get number 23.
Come on, Richard. You were always there.
I don't know, Tom.
Rich, I'm guessing you finally managed to stay with us or do it for me.
So, he brought it.
Now let's grab memory shard number 5. It's to the left of you on the desk. Interact with the glasses and slap out the bit of recollection there. Memory shard number 5.
So that's how you found me?
Yes.
Mr. Rekovich?
That's not true. You thought he deserved.
Now, once this one is done, immediately to the left of that is Mentor's Diary number 6, Growing Apart. So that should be your 6th one. Make sure to grab that before moving on. And if we hit back out and then just to the left of that, that is Music Sheet Part 2. So the 3rd one out of 3, combine them together. Now we can actually finish the piano solving puzzle. Right, so that's where we're heading next. So sort of head down past this table in the middle of the room again, so to the left. It can be a bit disorientating and a little bit confusing, to be honest. But it's all just sort of heading up through the doorway there. Apologies, you can get quite lost easily. But there's not much of a puzzle. All we're doing is putting the music sheet on it, and for some reason that is what will... that is the Viagra what this spirit well needed. So, make sure to grab the energy from the spirit well. Head to the double doors now. Right here. So we're going to go through here. Now, of course, we couldn't get past this bit thanks to the goddamn moths. But again, there's a few more collectibles that we need to get at the bottom of the stairs. And the first one is Mentor's Diary number 7, A New Home. So head past this little bit of table right here. The camera's going to change. Head to the right side room. And this is where Mentor's Diary number 7, A New Home is. This will also unlock you the achievement, Devouring Darkness, for getting all Richard's diaries in a single playthrough. So hopefully you would have got that achievement as well. Again, if not, sadly, you will have to start a new game and get up to this point again. So memory shard number 6, out of that room and then just go to the left, interact with this painting, do the recollection type of jizz magoni, and that is memory shard number 6.
Uncle Richard, my arms are getting tight. You've been drawing...
Almost done. A girl.
Did you love...
Yes. Firas.
Richard, I'm getting a weird vibe from... There's something else.
Something weird going on right there, isn't it? Anyway, memory shard number 7. Go back down to the opposite side of the room now. Sort of head to the right, and you're going to see this teddy bear on this table. Or doll, sorry. Doll, teddy bear. It's all the same creepy-ass crap, isn't it? Again, do the same thing, and that'll unlock memory shard number 7. Ooh, Uncle Richard. You goddamn creep! And finally, memory shard 8. If you go to the left, past the stairs... There's going to be this little, tiny little area you can go into. This is memory shard number 8. And that'll be the last one for this room. And old Mr. Nonsical Richard, what have you done?
Oh, God. It feels...
So now we can just go back into the middle of the room. A wheelchair is going to wheel out of absolutely nowhere. Again, no thoughts. You're just like, that's normal. Apparently it is in a medium's life. So interact with it. And quite frankly, we are coming up to my least favorite part of the game. So there's going to be a couple of cutscenes. Again, watch them all you want. Obviously, I'm just going to keep smashing through it. But we are going to be experiencing our first vision with Thomas, the guy who we are after.
Where is it? Where is it? God fucking damn it! Thomas. I wasn't expecting you. Is everything all right, my friend?
Did you do it, friend?
Did I? What?
My daughter. My 13-year-old daughter.
So So now we're going to start getting a little bit more of an understanding. Richard is a child eater, 13-year-old daughter. I'd want to exact my complete revenge as well. But we are now in Hell, or the alternate reality as Thomas. And again, I'll explain why it's my least favourite part in just a moment. But we're basically looking for the monster, which is supposed to be inside Richard, which is why he was doing these things. So, as soon as these little anime tentacle porn tentacles are about to attack, press the right bumper once, and that should sort of deflect them off. And sometimes if you do it correctly, it'll put them on fire and kill them for good. But yeah, these bits are... This first bit is around 25 to 30 minutes long, and it definitely felt like a bit of a drag, to be honest. It slowed the game down incredibly. I just wasn't a big fan. You might feel different about it. It might be a bit of a better break for you. Personally, I was not a fan. I think it just went on for a little bit too long. But of course, it is key for the story, so it is how it goes. So once we enter the house, go to the left. I'm going to interact with this knife on the table, the father's knife, and we're going to start to see things from Richard's point of view when he was a young lad, how things started, etc., etc. So go through the only open doorway and just keep on going, listening to the dialogue until you get to the next room.
You know what? Why don't you keep it?
But it's your lucky knife.
And now it's yours. You'll need it. I'm leaving tomorrow.
What? No! But where are you going?
The army is heading out west, and I'll be going with them.
But... no! I don't want you to go!
I don't want to go either, son. But sometimes, what we want isn't what's important. Do you understand?
When will you come back?
Take care of your mother, Richard. You're the man of the house now.
Welcome to the next room, then. There are no collectibles in Thomas's visions, so you don't have to worry about any collectibles at all. So head round, go onto the desk. You have to interact with all the items. This is basically for us to continue, so interact with the pipe. Get your insight out, open up the drawer, and grab the book. And then if you go over to the fireplace now, you have to interact. Well, basically, if you have a look here, there are vines and tentacles and things that guard in the way. We need to get rid of them to be able to jump through the painting. So that's why we are heading to the fireplace. There's a letter in the fireplace we need, but you have to actually interact with the items on top of the fireplace first. So the medal for one, and then on the right hand side there's going to be a framed photo. There he goes. Well done. Got there eventually, didn't I? And now that'll douse out the fire somehow. And now we can interact with it, use the father's knife on it, and basically we can jump through the painting now, for my even least favouritest bit.
Grief. Anger.
And you might think, oh, blue skies, it's a lovely looking environment. It's kind of a maze, and it kind of annoyed the crap out of me a little bit. You know, he doesn't exactly move like a like Usain Bolt, does he? But basically, our job is to follow the voices and interact with a few things that are on benches. So head to the left first. And then around the corner, there's going to be a photo to interact with on a bench.
Move faster, damn it!
Come on, Richard. My arms are getting tired. Almost done.
So from here, we're going to slowly, apparently, very slowly, jog our way to the left now. And then around this little area, it can be quite disorientating, but you should be used to the controls by now, hopefully. And turn to the left right now. Don't go straight, go to the left. And then just go down. We're going to see a bench with a little bit of bread and everything on it. There it is. And basically what they're going to say, if you go in the wrong way, the girl will say something like, silly you, go the other way, or you'll know if you go in the wrong way. But I will actually show you now what happens. So from here, go to the right. You can just see it doesn't look like it is, but it is a gap on the right there. And you need to go straight up, basically, because I'm going the wrong way. There we go. She'll laugh at you for going the wrong way, basically just laughing at you, demeaning you. I think that's disgusting, personally. But no, I'm joking. We're just going to go straight down. So yeah, if you are going the wrong way, she'll say something like, this way, silly. Over here. And just keep going straight for now. And then we should be good for this part, actually. Go over the bridge, and then we're going to end up back in the room. Or in the main bit of the house.
Ages. I was starting to get bored waiting for you. Hey! Hey. You see that? The storm's coming.
It's a big one. We should probably go. Same spot tomorrow?
I'll be there.
Cute, Richard. Real cute.
Yeah, Richard, you asshole. So all we need to do now is just go back through the door and enter into the main sort of hall area, or the main foyer. And there is a door there, I promise. Promise I'm not just going off my nut. Here we go. Congratulations, Thomas, you can walk in a straight line. Luckily, the hallway isn't as long as when we first appeared there. Now there's only one way up, and it's the left side staircase. So keep going on, heading up. All these paths in these visions and dreams are extremely linear. Just one way to go, really. Can't get lost. Congratulations if you do.
I can take care of you. I promised Dad I'd protect you.
I know, honey. And he would be so proud of you. But sometimes, a brave heart is just not enough.
So, we need to give this anime porn tentacle 3 items before he loses his nutballs. Again, very easy to do. The first one, you can do it in any order, literally doesn't matter. But the first one, I grab the book off the bookshelf. And then what you just need to do with this then is place it down in front of him. Again, whatever you put down, he's going to say something that ridicules you. And then he's going to try and attack you after the third item. So the other two items are on the table, but you can only do one item at a time.
Why the hell would I want that?
Real fucking charmer, that one.
So as soon as that goes, be prepared to parry him. He's going to attack you straight away. If it doesn't work the first time, just leave it a tiny little bit longer until he burns to death and dies. So, there we go again. Now we can just exit and then enter into the next room.
Get the hell away from me!
Gladly.
That is quite sound advice, by the way. If anyone's coming up to you, they're not supposed to. Either kick them in the balls and run, or just give them a little cut on the balls. Either way, the balls hurt. Anyway, grab whatever was on the bed. There's a few tentacles we're just going to slap out of our way. again using the right bumper as soon as they go to hit you, until we get to the next room again. It may seem interesting, this part, but it is the same sort of annoying part of the maze that we have to get through again to get through to the other side. Get very tedious very quick, these sort of mazes. But again, we're just following the sort of straight line for now. We are going to get tentacles that will attack us. There are two just up here, so be very careful. You don't die straight away, so don't worry about it. But just to the left here, there is a photo on the bench. We need to actually interact with these to be able to progress the story forward as well. So it's not just me being cute. Now then, just carry on.
Hello?
As soon as you see the split path, we're going to be taking the right side path this time. Try not to walk into the lamppost. And then head to the right again as we get to the end. It's where we're going to see some more bread and stuff.
I'm sorry. That's all I could bring. That's all right, Richard.
So from this point, we're just going to go in a straight line. So keep heading left here till the camera changes. Go up. We're going to see a little bag on a rock here. Poifek. So this bit is basically done with. All we're going to be doing is following the straight line linear path now until we get to the end and we are back in the big mansion house again.
This isn't funny. Richard! Here you are.
Oh, hey.
I waited for you, by the maze. I was afraid something happened to you.
I'm fine. I don't like being alone.
Are you sure you're all right?
I said I'm fine!
Hey, if something happened, you can tell me. Just let me...
Get the hell away from me!
Okay, Richard. I get the picture. Doesn't change a goddamn thing.
Mommy? What's going on?
Shh, listen to me, Richard. Listen to my every word. Some men will come to our house tonight.
But why? What do they want?
Shh, it's okay. I told them to come.
The hell is this? No! Stay away from me! Stay back! Get away from me, you bastards! No! No! Let go of me! No, please don't!
No, this next bit is very simple as well. There are three items that we need to interact with. They're basically straight in front of us. The button prompt will appear. Sort of small white dots. So there's two right here, and there'll be another one on the left-hand side. A noose will come down, and we just got to interact with that to get through the next part of the painting. Simple, bruh!
commits an unforgivable crime that... swiftly punished.
Couldn't have happened to a nicer guy.
Yes, Thomas, tedious is exactly right. Exactly right. So you see the split path here. We are just going to kill this tentacle, but we need to go to the left to pick up a painting first. So I do carry on straight, but you need to go to the left there. I'll just correct my mistake. So there we go. So we need to go to the left-hand side, grab a little drawing on this tree stump right here, and then we can go carry on going straight. So, shove these tentacles right up your death streak. You thought I was going to say something then, didn't you? Yeah, we're just going to kill these two. Don't go straight there. We're going to go left where the first tentacle was. And there is going to be another item on a bench that we can interact with right here. So, just interact with that. There's no dialogue or anything, so you just need to interact with it once. But we are going to go straight down. Because there's another item on this bench that we can interact with, so make sure to do that first. And then we can go back down. So sort of come towards the screen, and we're going to go the way we killed the second tentacle. Now, so there you go, back up, go to the right, and there's going to be a total of four tentacles on this little linear path that we're going to destroy. There is only one way that we are going to keep going for now.
Please, I need...
Oh boy, that don't look good. Lily seems a little bit dead.
Awkward. So basically, we are going now the path where we found those two items earlier on. That is actually the end of this part, but it can be a little bit tricky here. So go right as soon as we get out of this little area. And just head on straight for the moment. When there's going to be a split path, we're going to take the right path. I accidentally take the left one, but obviously correct my mistake again. So here we're going down the right path, because this is just where the first tree stump collectible is. We already got that. So down the right, baby. Okay, lovely, lovely. Now go to the left. Again, this is sort of a split path, but we're going to take the first left, and then it's literally straight path all the way home.
Lily!
It was pretty overwhelming at first. Thomas being like me, but different somehow. I guess I don't know. This time, it wasn't just a feeling.
So I'm not actually going to spoil it for those who actually watched the cutscene, but oh my god, what in the hell? That's pretty goddamn creepy. But anyway, we are now finally ended that flipping ridiculous bit. We are playing as Marianne again. Now, as we get to this area, there's a split path we can take, and we're going to be going left first. So go left, and then left again. And we're going to find this postcard number 6. Can't stop, won't stop, on a bench. And that will be, as I said, postcard number 6. Won't stop believing. Anyway, Echo 24 is directly underneath it as well. So just walk down a little bit into this phone, this payphone. Oh, man. I'm a boomer. I remember all these payphones and things. Before the mobile and cell phones came in and ruined our lives. Anyway, Echo 24, yeah? Q.
This one felt subdued. Like if someone lit a match in a giant freezer.
So, now we can head up and then down these little bit of steps right here. More steps to go down. And there's actually going to be another postcard. Postcard number 7. Poor Ting. And as you can see, directly in front of us, we've got the telescope. And just to the right of that, on a bench, will be, as I said, postcard 7. Poor Ting. New, 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 new. You make my heart sing. Gotta stop singing. Gotta stop annoying people with that. Sorry. So, anyway, when we get the postcard, go to the right, and there's only one path we can go into the Neva Nature Park. Walk down just a little bit, and there is going to be yet another split path. They all go the exact same way, but if you take the left path, this is where we can find postcard 8. Harder and harder. That's what my missus says to me, and I refuse. So go to the left, and postcard 8, harder and harder, is going to be on a bench.
Place? Or something else entirely?
But for now, once we are done with this, we are literally just going to be following the very linear path once again until we basically we'll see a deer on the floor, looks delicious, probably not in that state, and then we climb up a rock and get a cutscene.
From the inside. These animals, they look used up, like something sucked the life out of them.
So as soon as this cutscene ends, once again, we're going to be going split path. You can either follow the dog up the hill, but first, we're going to be going to the right. And we're going to be grabbing a very easily missable postcard, number 9, Whispers in the Dark. So it's kind of hard to tell, but it's behind these bushes right here. It's on a bench behind these bushes. There it is. So again, make sure to be grabbing this postcard before you head up the hill following the dog. Little doggy dog. And again, when you do that, it is literally just following the dog. Once again, down another linear path. Linear is my favorite word of the day.
So, there I was, following my new best friend, hoping he wasn't as lost as I was. I remember thinking he could lead me to his owner. In a way, I guess he did.
So directly in front of us, you can see a little light. It's kind of like a little shack. Now, there's no collectibles. You don't need to do anything here. But what I actually end up doing is come in here, and I end up just feeding the dog because he's a little doggy and he looks so cute. And there's nothing wrong with it. So, yeah, apologies. I've just sort of gone off here, but there is nothing that we need to collect or anything. We're just going to feed the dog because he a good boy. So, when we do that, we're going to nip off to the right, and we're going to get to a tent, and then another cutscene's going to happen.
Scent? Hey! Anyone in there?
So, as the cutscene ends, do not interact with the tent first. Do not interact with it. Rather, head to the left on the bench and you're going to see postcard 10, a new companion. So if you end up interacting with the tent, you cannot come back to this area and you will have missed this. And I can guarantee that would have just pissed you off. So make sure to grab this before interacting with said tent. Anyway, when we finish with postcard number 10, a new companion. Sounds like a new film in the Star Wars franchise, but now we can interact with the tent and find postcard 11, regrets, just below you, right next to the shoe. With all 11 collected, that should get you the all that's left unsaid achievement. So again, hopefully you would have got this one as well. Sadly, if not, it's a new game for you. Pick up the photo 3 staff photo. That's all that we need to collect for the rest of the game. Again, it doesn't get an achievement or anything, but now we can interact with the corpse. He's looking a bit... well, I bet he's had better days, to be honest. With that, a cutscene will appear and another chase scene will start. So immediately after the cutscene ends, it's not as hard or difficult as the others have been, but it's literally just going in a straight line. Run, rabbit, run! So, that makes us not dead again, because we are legends at running. But again, all this bit is... the kind of is just a lot of linear paths now, sort of, as we head towards the last half of the game. I think we're about over halfway through the game now. So we're just going to keep climbing down, and as we get to this next section, we're going to take a right and head on down there.
What? Who's there?
don't fall.
No risk. No.
This isn't real. It can't be.
Jack?
So head straight in front of us then, and you can just see the little button prompt. It's basically Jack's ties. So now we're like, bruh, what in the actual fudge cake and the old fudge mouth dildo is going on? But if you want to find the way, of course, use your insight to find where the ghost footprints are going. It's all basically just through a few cracked walls for now, and moving this out of the way.
You're not him. You're not him.
Where have you sent me?
I've helped you pass on.
I shouldn't be here, Mary. It's all your fault.
So open up this gate and just take a look and interact with the photo immediately to your left on the table. And then what's going to happen is we're going to get another chase scene. The mall once again is going to be after us. And a fairly, it all ends, you know exactly what's going to happen. So we're going to walk forward a little bit and then he's going to dart at us and we need to sprint. So just run for it until we get to the end. Not too difficult again though.
Hit me!
And fudge this, baby. We out of it. Go! Once we get under here, just immediately pull this concrete thing. Can't remember the name. So much stuff's going on. Just pull it away. And even though he's a demon and can walk through walls, apparently he can't walk through these little bits of rubble, which is always handy for us. So... concrete mixer, that was the one I was after then. I couldn't think, so much going on. So get your bolt cutters out and then we can head through the gate. Again, basically, we need to be turning on a generator to get rid of said demon now. But it does take, it's around 5 to 6 minutes long, this section, but it's not too bad. Whip out your bolt cutters again. Remember, it's right trigger and left trigger together. If you haven't figured that out by now, then... how have you come this far in the game? So, don't worry about the maw. He's not going to come and attack us here just yet. But as you can see, we've got a generator. You can try and turn it on, obviously out of gas for your ass. And there's a lever that we also need as well, because for some reason somebody's taken it off and placed it elsewhere. Why? Why has somebody done that? Idiota! Anyway, head through the little arch, and we're going to already get the gas can, which is extremely helpful, and it's still completely full of gas. Who's leaving that there? But what we're going to do is just climb up here. We need to use the bolt cutter on this bit. And again, it's all... this is just fairly simple, obvious stuff. We're going to use the bolt cutter. This bit of bridge is going to fall down, and the maw is actually going to come up now, because he's like, huh, I hear ya. Even though we can't walk through walls, he can actually just come up through floors, apparently. Legend. Legend of a demon. So we're just going to the right. It's fairly obvious. We've got a few little balancing sections to get across through now, so just carry on with that. Just try not to fall and die. That'll always help your cause.
Here.
And here is the last sneaking stealth section that we have to do. This isn't for an achievement, but of course if you get caught, you'll die, and nobody wants to die really, do they? So just hang a banger for 2 seconds. It doesn't really do much. But there are a set of crows in the middle of this little part which will distract him. But what we can do is just head to the right, sort of behind these boxes. He's just going to keep playing with the light up there for some reason. He doesn't go wandering around. But you can see the crows just on the ground in front of us. Obviously, if he hears them, he's obviously going to come running. So just be aware of that. So if you do end up making them fly away like that, head behind this sort of wooden fence right here. Hold your breath again. Ooh, he does look like a scary old dog. And after that, then, he's just going to nip on back. So once again, there's nothing now to distract him. But what we need to do, there is a little button that we need to press just behind him. So head to the left, very slowly, of course, always sneak in. And you can see the button prompt then. Use it on the rope. We need to use the bolt cutters. Use it once, and then that will get him out of the way. He's in the gap, which we need to get through. So that is actually the easiest stealth section of the lot, to be honest. But we are through. And once again, now it is just yet another linear path. So we've seen the exit. Now let's do this.
Not with that thing in my way.
Jack says hello. Or was it? Why did you send him here? Why, oh, why?
So as we cross this little bit right here, you can just see on your right there's a little table and there is going to be the lever on it. Now, why make us go all the way around when we could have just sort of got something to bash ourselves? Ooh. Oh, Henlow! Yelps like a scared dog. So, very much like Jason Voorhees, he has something he is scared of. Electric and water, which, well, to be fair, everyone should be scared of. Like, why couldn't we have just got something to bash this bit of wood down, and then, you know, we would have taken a lot less time. But like I said, horror games don't do that. Any games don't do that. We're going to use the bolt cutters, and once again, even though it's a loud bang, the more doesn't come shooting over, which is good for us, actually. So we've finally done this little path then. So if you want, you can put the lever on first and then open it up. Don't worry, the maw's not going to be coming up. Okay. And you'll have to actually interact with the fuel top right there just to take it off. Interact with it again, put the fuel in, press the button, and the generator is good to go. Now, all we are doing, we just got to push it all the way forward until it goes in the water and gets rid of the maw. You are king or queen.
There you are.
Okay. It's still down there. Let's do something about it.
Come to me.
Shut your fucking mouth! God, I hope this is over.
Well, to be fair, that did look like it hurt. But that's what you get for being a dick, then. Don't try and kill me and wear my skin like a suit. Anyway, once we get out to this bit, we're just going to head once again just on a linear path until we see another cutscene with old Syedness on a swing. And then the two realities at once, we're going to start going through it again. but we are literally roughly around an hour away now from finishing the game.
Oh, yeah.
That's what it sounded like to me.
Gone.
So it's been a while since we got some collectibles, so, well, let's go and grab some, shall we? So as we see, we got the barn, big barn on the right, but if you head, stay outside and head to the sort of left, we are going to see a wheel and something on this little rock right here. It's like a little cigarette packet. You can't say fag packet anymore. That's a no-no in this day and age. But again, that's Echo 25, so make sure to interact with that. And then immediately after this one, as soon as you get back onto the screen, there is the wheel literally just to the right side of you. That's Echo 26.
All right, Richard. This is you and... Hey! Hey! He really messed you up, didn't he?
He tried to get to Richard, too. Didn't realize he was...
So now we can actually head in through the entrance. Now, when we get there, just stay in this little area before going into the main bit. Have a look at this sort of workbench on the left-hand side. Have a look at the picture, and that is Trouble Man's Note 7.
Hell's Angels, oh yeah.
Then look directly below you with this wooden statue of a horse, and that's Echo 27.
Oh yeah.
I'm sorry.
Smart man. Would you happen to know? I'd love.
Go away, clever girl.
So now we are good to go into the little garage bit. Garage bit. And if we head all the way to the back, we can see Echo 28 on, once again, sort of like a rock or a little bit of debris on the floor. But it is this tape recorder. This will, and should, if you've been following along, get us Echo 28. It should also get us an achievement tied to Henry's, I believe. Yes, Henry's Echoes. So as long as you've been collecting them all up to this point, you will get that achievement and Echo 28. Echo 29, then, is just on the desk behind it. It's a suitcase just on the bottom right-hand corner, so make sure to grab that one as well. And then interact with the same desk again and have a look, just have a look down. As you can see sticking out, it's a little piece of paper, and that is Trouble Man's Notes 8, something broken.
My ass, it's broken.
My back is broken. Spinal. Anyway, so once we're done here, we can actually now crack on with the puzzle. So have a look at the desk on the right-hand side upper corner. We need to grab this doll. Creepy. Why are dolls the creepiest crapping things in horror games? We need to go through the door and back outside. And we're going to place the doll on this bench. And then what that's going to do is actually give us enough energy. Now it's going to Viagra up the spirit well. And that's going to give us some energy that we can use. So head back in, and there's going to be like a hanging switch, which we need to use in just a little bit. But for now, head to where the garage door is and then go outside of your body. Remember, if you haven't got the spirit walking achievement yet, make sure to stick around for a couple of minutes to just to get it out of the way now as we come towards the end of the game. So head around the house, and we're going to head up and we're going to head inside. There we go. So walk forward, and now we can press the... Now we can actually use our spirit bomb. And that's actually going to get the switch on the middle of, in the middle of the floor there. That's going to get it to work. So press up. That's going to lift up this engine. I suppose you can't really lift that up unless you've got like a strong man with you at all times. But even then, they probably wouldn't want to go on this adventure. They'd be knackered by now. But we now finally have the hydraulic jack handle. We can use that. And where the garage door is underneath it, stick it in. Pump it up a few times, and then take a nap. No, are we still on about the same thing right here? No, but we are to use the jack handle, and then we can actually head up now to the burnt housing trousen. And we're actually going to be getting our last few memory shards here as well. So, go under.
The red house. Oh my god.
So, let us get the last two memory shards of the game. So, it would obviously, you'd think we go straight into the house. That's what we're not going to do, but we're going to go just in front of it. You can just see the button prompt there. And so interact with it. And it's kind of like a stopwatch or time watch or something. Do the whole point of recollection. And that's memory shard number 9.
You think you're tough when you hear them squeal and you beg me.
God.
Righto, mate, no worries. So to grab the last one, head to the left side of the house. It's going to be a gas can up against the wall. It's here somewhere. There it is. So grab that, interact with it. And once again, once we've done this and the dialogue unlocks, as long as you've been following along with the guide, you should have got all memory shards, all 10 of them. And now puzzling up the past should be yours as well. So happy days. That's no more memory shards we have to worry about now. Sadly, we are coming up to another Thomas section. Again, you might have enjoyed it, but me, personally not. And the way to do that is we just went past it. It's not in front of the house, but it's just a little bit to the left. So it can be kind of tricky to see. There it is then. So it's just like an item on the floor. But we are now getting the second vision of Thomas. Another long cutscene is going to play. Obviously, like I said, a couple of them. I've obviously been smashing them out. But let's get this. This is a little bit shorter, a little bit better and easier, but still, let's just get it out the way, huh?
Locked up tight, huh?
Wake up.
Fucking finally. I thought he'd never give us a chance. Okay, gotta move that. All work and no play.
So for a lot of the time then, it is once again just one long linear path, but we've got a new power in terms of we can move debris and rubble out the way. So just press X and then go in the direction of where you want to get rid of it. So obviously this time you'd press the left stick, left, get rid of the rubble that way. And that's pretty much it. We've got a little tiny stealth section we need to do. Don't worry about that noise. That is one hell of a noise, but you don't have to fight it or anything. It's just very, very easy. So for now, just keep following the path, and there are a few items again that we need to interact with on the way. So here we are then, we've entered this new room. This will be our main bit. You can take a look at the TV screen. You don't have to, but that is the kid that we are after. So to be able to continue, press A to interact with the desk. Pick up this reel right here. And then just go ahead and use it on the machine on the left. Again, you can have a look at that if you want to. But just put the reel in. It's going to start a little recording once you press play. And then we're good. You don't have to listen to it all here. The door's open now, so that's what we're going to be doing. We're just going to be nipping on. Again, it's just one long path for the minute. So, just enjoy whatever's going on.
He was led to believe you've been stealing meat from the working people of the Republic.
Where would they get that idea, I wonder?
You've been a very bad boy.
Let's just get this over with.
Given your line of work, you have... had ample opportunity to commit your crime. It is a crime against the people. Punishable by death. Anything to say in your defense?
I'm sorry, Henry.
So, this isn't even a tricky bit, but it is the trickiest bit of the section. So, you think this is where we need to go, and basically there's going to be a guy or a demon or something with a spotlight. Do not get caught in the spotlight because it can burn you and kill you. So, just wait until he goes the other side, and then make a bloody run for it. So, as you can see, it does start burning, but that's fine. So, head on up, and he's going to do it again. So, it's... Pretty easy to avoid. You just need to wait until he goes the complete other side with the spotlight, like now, then make a bloody run for it. Run, Forrest! Run! There we go. There's going to be a third section now, and we need to... Yeah, so just wait here, and then basically we need to be crawling underneath that bit. You can see it just in front of us, so go ahead and then just go underneath these bits of skin pigs or whatever that is. So that bit's fine. And he's going to appear yet again for a fourth time. So wait here until he goes up to the opposite side. And now we can sort of hide behind this statue. That give us enough darkness not to get burnt. And then as soon as it goes past us, then we can run. There we go. Make a break for it. So yeah, it's not too bad. It's not that difficult, but that is literally the hardest part of the section, if you want to call it that. So now we're just going to get these pigs moving. Take a bite if you want. You're already in hell, so it might even taste quite nice. Not that one that's just going past us, though. But when there's a gap, we're going to make a... we're going to go up. Just go around, and we're going to climb up onto the sort of ceiling beams. Just keep heading down until we see a beam that we can cross with the A button. There it is. So now obviously be careful, take your time. I don't actually know if you can fall off. I didn't, but you know, if you can fall off, then try not to. It would help your cause greatly. I almost did though. So there we go. So we need to interact. There's going to be a box on the right. We need to interact with that. And then a spirit well is going to Viagra itself out of nowhere for us. So when we do that, we can then go down the sort of only path that we can on these beams.
Always against, never with, always against, never with. Steady hand, deep emotions, against the grain. Always against, never with, always against, never with.
But be careful, stop right here. Because this guy pops up again, so again, we're just going to wait until he goes back down, then make a break for it. Go to the left and down, and then we can actually get through the painting now. So we're sort of coming closer to an end now. But this bit is over with.
Steady hand,
Good. That's good.
So again, I'm not sure, but I am pretty sure that you have to interact with everything to be able to progress the story forward a little bit. No, definitely that bit. But yeah, I'm sure you have to interact with these for the door to open for us to move on. Oh, you know what? Maybe I was wrong. Maybe we just needed to do it to be able to get this reel. So obviously press LB to use your insight. The reel is in the drawer. Whip that boy out. And then use it on the machine, of course, on the right again. It'll be the same sort of thing now. So there's going to be a lot of talking once you press the play button. But the door's going to open. And once again, it's going to be another bit of a linear path to go down. So just enjoy it. Take your time. Few things we need to interact with as well on the way.
No fear, no hesitation.
If you wanted me dead, I'd be dead already. So, what do you want?
I want to offer you a job.
I'm listening.
I've been doing this a long time. I've come to know people. See what makes them tick. See their potential.
Agreed. On one condition.
Huh?
The work I do for you, it stays at work.
That's the way we like it.
It has to. If it doesn't, I'm holding you accountable.
Welcome to the family.
Ever heard of Neva?
What's this?
So after a few minutes of walking and nothing's going on, we need to kind of defeat this skull dog, weird but very loud noise kind of dog. So immediately after the dog starts screaming at us, bad doggy, use your spirit force, put it to the right hand side of course, and that will, it won't kill it, but it will help us not die. So again, it's just a case then of climbing down and just going forward just a little bit, again, on the only path that you can. Obviously, on the beams, try not to fall and die. Once again, it comes in extreme handiness. Now, Thomas, didn't anybody tell you not to be a cocky little butthole until you actually finish what you're supposed to be doing? Do you know what it's like? Somebody gets cocky, and then they end up dying themselves, or... See? Don't be cocky with it until the very end. But actually, as long as you don't fall, you will be fine. So we're going to be using the Spirit Force one more time. Press the down button. Or press down on the left stick. That is eventually going to just crush this dude to death. It's kind of a good action line to say that, isn't it? Stay the fuck down. Well then, Thomas. So now we can move on through without any repercussions or any fear of death. Yes. Oh, so that young boy's in a wheelchair. Now, I'm taking this as a direct quote from South Park, okay? Cripple fight! That's from South Park, so don't blame me, okay? But basically, it's just one of those sections where, again, we're looking at a table, and then we're going to follow a little wheelchair through a door.
Say goodbye to him.
I'm not sure if that's a good idea. I have work on my mind.
I see.
Then again, maybe I should. Do you think I should?
Whatever you wish, dude.
Simon? Where are you, boy?
Dad?
Hey there, champ.
Are you going away again?
Daddy has to go to work. Once I get back, fishing. You'd like that, wouldn't you?
I don't like it when you go.
I know. Sometimes Daddy needs to work. It's good for all of us. You understand?
Yes, Father.
Don't worry, kid. This'll all be over soon.
Tricks won't work on me, old man!
Thomas Rekovich. My father. Was he?
And that, my fellow viewers, is the end of Thomas's vision. So, now we can finally go back as Marianne. We are going to get an achievement for discovering the Red House. And as we enter, go into the sort of second room on the right, in the top right-hand corner. And this is where we can find Trouble Man's Note 9, Demons. I think I'd rather go on a big collectible hunt than have to do any of those Thomas sections again. But here we go. So there's going to be like a kind of a long-winded puzzle now. So you will see a photo frame on the floor. So pick that one up, sort of on the character's right-hand side. There's also going to be another family photo to pick up on the left-hand side of Marianne. So make sure to pick up those two. And then if we go forward, we are going to see a fireplace. There's a doll's house on the right and a bench on the left. But in front of us is a fireplace. Now, to get this on the go, pick up the framed wedding photo. We need to do this in a particular order. So on the left, put the framed wedding photo. In the middle, put the circle family frame. The framed family photo, make sure it's the circle one. And then do the framed family photo, the square one on the right-hand side. That is going to, well, that's going to open something up, I tell you. But now what we can do, there's a mirror at the other end of this house. You can have a look at the bench. It literally does nothing, serves no purpose, and has just to sit on. But as we can see, we can enter through the window, or the mirror, sorry. And we basically need to be visiting a few of these rooms, interacting with the mirror. But for now, we'll just use the razor blade on the old... Now, this one looks like a heart more than the skin between your balls. So, I've got to stop saying that. I bet every time I say that, a lot of guys watching have just gone, "Oh, man, stop saying that, you douchebag." Anyway, grab the little butterfly inside and grab the mask, which is on the underneath of this part here. Mask of Joy. So we need to be finding 4 butterflies and 3 masks. It's not an overly difficult puzzle. You know what, know what you're doing when we get into it. But for now, we can exit the mirror here. And now we can interact with the dollhouse because it's now open. Again, creepy, but that doesn't put off old Mary Mary. Now, on the bottom floor, you can interact with and pick up this tiny mirror. And then what you can do then is actually interact with it on one of the 2 bedrooms at the top. So we'll put it on the right-hand side first. Something would have shifted. So if you go back and interact with the mirror again, the rooms are different. So it's all connected. So when we move the mirror, we can enter into different rooms. And obviously, there's going to be a few things that we need to do. So head right to the back wall next to the bed. Do the whole slicing with the razor blade and pick up another butterfly in there.
Another one of those butterflies.
So at this point, there is an item that we need to put on this little, what's it called? But for now, we're going to have to just leave and go into the next room. So out of here, go ahead and go back to the dollhouse. Actually, the fireplace and the bench is nothing now. Pick up the toy from the right-hand side bedroom and then put it onto the left side. And then we're going to enter back through the mirror again. So, yeah, it's kind of... This bit's a bit kind of tedious. Back and forth, but it's not too bad at all, really. Have a look on the sort of desk rock type thing directly in front of you, whatever you want to call it. And get the fish toy. It doesn't belong here because it looks like it belongs in the bin. Or out to sea where all the animals can get scared by it. Have a look at this heart-shaped heart, skin bag, I suppose. And we're going to slice that one. That is going to be the next butterfly to grab. Lovely, that's the third out of four. And then have a look on the bed. We're going to interact with the pillow, move the pillow out of the way. I do. Creepy. Anyway, get the mask of calm. Calm. So that's two masks and three butterflies. We need one more of each. But if we have a look on this right-hand side, get the bit of ball sacking skin down. And what we're going to see is like three just dolls, I suppose, with hoods up. If you want, these are where we're supposed to be putting the masks. But of course, we've only got two out of the three for now. So again, it's going to be slice it down. Have a look if you want, but we're going to be going back through the mirror regardless. Now, once again, we're going to be messing around with the mirror. So take it from the left, pop it on the right, and head back in through the mirror. This time, of course, we got the fish toy. We can't actually chuck it in the bin. We do need it. So back through the mirror, go to the little children's mobile on the left-hand side there. Put the fish toy on it, and that means we can now then slice it open and get our fourth out of four butterflies. We are almost done with this section of the game, by the way. It's taken a while, but we are almost there. So what you need to do then with these four butterflies, luckily it's in the same room, so go to the foot of the bed again, and you just need to put all four butterflies in with the same shapes. So it's fairly obvious if you just take a little look at it. But if you'd want to know, it is red butterfly, yellow butterfly, blue butterfly, and then white butterfly. You can always tell with the shapes of the butterflies anyway, but that's what it is. So it's red, yellow, white, and then blue. Sorry. Red, yellow, white, and blue. Apologies. And then what that's going to do is open it up. It's going to... Let her burn. Oh, come on, man. That's a little harsh. New butthole. But it's going to get us the final mask, the mask of wonder. So now... Now what we can do is go back, change the mirror to the left side of the bedroom, go back through the mirror, and then interact and put the all three masks on the creepy ass dolls just sitting there doing nothing.
What is this?
I know. I under...
What the hell?
We can make them understand. Make them feel.
Okay, so I'm pretty sure you can do them in any order. That's fine. But what we need to do now, as soon as we regain control of Marianne, we need to head back to the mirror because we're going to be attacked by moths. So as soon as this bit's over and you get out of here, run straight for the mirror now, which is directly behind you. There it is. Get out. Press A. A. And then we're out. Mirror's broken. God damn it. But that reveals an entrance to the basement. And this is where we're going to get another couple of achievements, including the last two echoes. So once again, we're going to just jump down, head down. Lily she. Shishi Lily. Anyway, what we're going to do then is head to the character's right, sort of, there's a Trouble Man's notes 10, the missing piece. So when you came down, you were going to go left, but it's the character's right. Confusing, but just make sure to get this one. So Trouble Man's notes 10, and then if you go to the right of that, just in this little room, there's going to be Trouble Man's notes 11, found a way. So grab that too. So get out of this room and head towards the center of it. There's basically going to be a little shoe on a chair. So keep going down, and it's just at the forefront of the screen right there. You can just see the button prompt. So that is the shoe. That is echo number 30 out of 32. So go ahead and slap that on your face, I suppose.
Tell me about the fire, Lily.
No.
No?
The voice. But...
Oh, Lily.
And from this shoe, if you just keep heading up the screen, so past this pillar right here, keep heading up into the next sort of little area on the workbench is a teddy bear. So interact with that. This will be Echo 31. Now, for me, it does unlock here, but it might not unlock until you get the next Echo, which is just literally 5 seconds walk away. But again, if you have been following along, this should be Echo 31, and it should unlock you the achievement either now, or if you just head up a little bit and to the right, slightly, ever so slightly, you can see this heroin needle. And that'll be Echo 32 out of 32. So hopefully, once again, you would have gotten the achievement. Again, big apologies if somehow you managed to miss one and you have to go through the game again. I feel your pain. But just to the right of that, get the Trouble Man's Note 12, a different kind of sickness. And that will be all the collectibles for this area. So now we can move on. And we've basically just got one more big area left to do now before the end of the game. And it is the water pump section. So where the shoe, Echo 30, the shoe was, there's a little gap in the wall. And we're going to head through that. So there is the Echo 30, the shoe. And just to the right of that then is the gap in the wall. Now what you have to do is find out what number the code is, blah blah blah, have a look around at stuff, but I'm going to tell you right now, it is 1966, and it should be the same for everyone's game. So 1966, that will enter the door, and we can head on through, but be prepared to be chased again. Again, it's just it's a short section, but just be prepared. Eventually, we are going to get there. Head to the left when you go through this room. Bloody camera angles confusing the crap out of us. But once again, be prepared to run. Told you it was very short, but as soon as we go straight ahead of us, we can get Troubled Man's Notes 13, Separation. So make sure to pick that one up as well. So these are the only collectibles we got left now in this area, Troubled Man's Notes. So quite a bit to do then before we end the game. So just keep going straight down. Once again, it can seem a bit confusing, but it's not too bad. We're going to head down. We actually need to get rid of this ball bag skin right here. So head through the door on the left. Now it looks like there are many ways to go, but as has been the case, it's not really. You just sort of head up to the right. We're heading up the stairs now. There will be points we can go downstairs, but for the minute, we cannot get through. So head straight on through. No need to go up the other end. You can have a look sort of off the edge there, because we have a way out, but we need to be doing a little, well, kind of a large puzzle, actually, to be able to get out. So head on straight through. And again, there's only one way to go down. Make sure to interact with the lever and turn the electric off first, so, you know, we don't die. And then on the big set of consoles right there, there is going to be Trouble Man Note 14, A Relic of the Past. So again, make sure to pick that one up before we move on. But we'll be back in this room a couple of times, so don't worry if you miss it the first time. So, head through the left now. Interact with the door. That will open up this door. And just head on through, as is per usual. Now, this is a fuse box that we need to be getting to work. And, of course, there's only one way to do that. And that is with Hell Marianne, the old blondie. So, head back to the right. It'll be kind of like this. Coming back to this room and then going back and then coming back, going forward. Turn the electric back on. Then when we get into this area, the first set of steps that you can see going down, we will be doing our out-of-body experience. So again, just to remind you, if you still haven't got the Spirit Walker achievement for spending 10 minutes outside your body, it is best to do it right now and get it out of the way. So as you can see then, there is a spirit well, which we are definitely going to need, and we're going to need it a couple of times. Try the double and triple energy thing again if you want. Just makes you feel like a big man, big woman, doesn't it? Makes you feel like a big dog. Anyway, so from here we can actually head left now that we have what we need. Head straight down into the next room. And then down these steps, right? Meow. So if you just keep walking sort of in a straight line, sort of to the right here, and from this open door, we can actually go left up another doorwell. Another door. So you can actually just nip on past it and up through this open door. And then up to a locked door, which we cannot obviously get through as real life Marianne. So we are going as Blondie Marianne. So if we head up the stairs right here, there's obviously a big reason why we've done this. We're going to be switching on the fuse box now. So this path, there's only one way you can go at the minute. You're not going to get lost unless you accidentally turn around back at yourself and then you're like, huh, what a flub am I? So this area should look familiar. This is the console command section. Head through the door on the left and then press and hold RT and release a big Viagra-style shock to the system. That's actually going to get the fuse sorted, so the consoles will actually work for us now. So at this point, we can just head back on ourself now, but instead of going all the way back up to the console to do all that, as soon as you get past this doorway and head left of the little bit, go down these staircases right here. Of course, real life Marianne won't be able to get through because she's not much of a diver and she's probably going down stuff. But as Blondie, Hell, Marianne, we're going to head down. And with the little bit of energy that we've got left, we need to be using this on the moss to get past. There we go, so just about get past there. And there's going to be another spirit well. Now, this may seem a bit pointless, but we've basically got a full lot of energy now, which is exactly what we need. So obviously, you don't have to go through the moths again, but this time we are going back to the console section, so get there. Alright then, so in terms of the puzzle, what we have to do now is basically get rid of the water in each chamber, the west of the east chamber. To do this, on the water pump 1, press the right button. That'll get rid of the water in the west chamber. Then we can go down, turn a valve, and that will be that portion done. Then we can come up and then do the east chamber. Simple, yo. The Moor is going to be here, but he's not going to be able to do much somehow, even though he can see us through glass. So yeah, water pump 1, empty the water in the west chamber, and then head left through the door. And that's literally all we need to do, is just go, turn the water valve, and then put the water back in there. With a lot of dialogue and commentary now from the Mao. So, keep heading in, and then head down. Of course, this is where water was before, and now it is not. So head down and down and down, and then just in front of us, of course, use your summon shield so you get past the moths. That's why we got the extra bit of energy a little bit earlier on. And then just press X to interact with the water valve. Then we'll be going back up to the console command section.
Yeah. Now it's ready to gulp down some water.
So glad you're here.
All the others.
Not enough. Never enough. Never full.
Never warm. And her.
Oh!
worn out rag.
Ooh, worn out old rag. That's harsh. So here we are back at the console command section anyway. So this time then, to get everything up and running and to continue, go to water pump 1 and press the left button. And then press the right button on water tank 1, which is just underneath here. Then go to water pump 2. And click the left button once. So wait until that goes halfway. Now, of course, because the central chamber is full, we can't actually click that again. So what we actually need to do is now press the water pump button, water pump 1 right button once. So water pump 1, the left button, bloody hell. So water pump 1, the left button once, and then press water pump 2, the left button again. That will completely drain out the east chamber for us to go ahead and carry on. Head to the right this time, out of there, and we'll be going down this staircase. Again, don't panic, the Maw is not about, even though it sounds like he is, so don't be worrying about him. Just keep going right, get some more energy if you think you need it. It's always worth having a bit of full energy for us, just in case, because there is another big moth section coming up. Otherwise, we can just keep heading down the steps. And, you know, just to add literally 20 seconds onto the game, the valve isn't there, but as you can see, that's where the valve's supposed to be. But we just keep running backwards, and we're going to see a locker where the actual valve is. We need to cut the bolts. It literally, to me, that's just pointless, because who in real life hides a valve wheel in a locker? Unless you're planning to steal it and sell it for a couple of quid, but I probably don't advise that. So grab the wheel, go back on yourself, interact with it, and then head. When you turn it, we're going to head back up to the central command system.
That's it. Second tank ready for duty.
Pretty, pretty girls. So many dolls to play with. Such pretty things to wear. Lillian. Francis. Nurse Ursula.
And so, once we get here, there is a particular button combination that we have to do in order to complete it. So, water pump 2, right 1. Here we go. And then water pump 1, right 1. Then it's water tank 2. Press the left button once. It's water tank 2, left once. Water pump 2, right 1. There it is, water pump 2, right 1. Water pump 1, left 1. So that's water pump 1, left 1. And then water pump 2, left once. And finally, it should be water pump 1, left once. And that means we are done with this section and we can carry on. And we are literally about 9 minutes away from completing the game now. So, woohoo! Let's get it to the end, baby. So we're heading right out of the door. As soon as I take a quiet reflection to celebrate. So head down this staircase once again, basically where the second water valve was. Now we've got one more small section with the Maw. We're basically going to trick him and then fludge him up for good. So just keep heading down. Keep on swimming. Or walking. So obviously we're going to head past water valve 2. Obviously we don't need to do anything with that anymore. But there should be a newly opened door. But make sure to quickly use your summon shield, the right bumper. Get past this little ball of moth boys right here. Blech. So, what we have to do, we don't have to sneak past this guy this time, or this ting, but we do have to trick him. No, never again, hun. Never again. Just me and my kids from now on, hun. All you men are nothing but snakes, mate. So, anyway. You shoved that toy up your butt, that wasn't me. That's your pain. So, go outside your body and then quickly run to the gap in the hole in the right. He's going to chase us. Mash the B button and then, as real life Marianne, run immediately to the fuse box he was guarding and then press the X button. That'll slap him up. That'll destroy all the toy cards out of his butt and all of the moths out of him. Door will open. That's how you do it! Come on! And let's grab the last few collectibles as well, shall we? So, head down the newly opened door, and there's a door on the left which is open. The others are not open, so this is the only place you can go. Head down these two steps and come back towards the screen, and there, right there on the shelf is Trouble Man's Notes 15, a thin line. I thought they were talking about my hairline for a second then, I got a bit worried. I'm going bald, damn it! So, what we have to do now is... The doors are not working at the minute. So I thought they would open up immediately, but what you have to do is interact with this fuse box, switch any levers that you can. The same fuse will always go, so you need to be taking that one out. That will actually now open the door. So just go ahead, go back out to where we came with the three doors. And that door is going to open, so head on through. Literally, you've got nothing to worry about now. There's not going to be anyone, or the Maw's not going to attack us or anything. Head forward, and you can just see on the fuse box on the left-hand side, before you go in this door, there is a new fuse for us. So take that out and just go back to the original fuse box. Pop that one in. And now flick down levers 1, 2, and 4. If you turn on the 3rd and 4th one, that'll be too much power and it won't work. So you need to get it dead on 50 right in the middle. That'll bring back the power. Happy days. So, let's go and get these last few Trouble Man's Notes, shall we? So immediately out of this room, head straight ahead of you into the kitchen, the newly opened door on the right. Head sort of towards the back, not the back of the counter, but the sort of forefront of the screen. That is where the Trouble Man's Notes 16 is. Sometimes it's just a bit tricky to explain. Back may seem back, but forward may... whatever. Anyway, just me and her. So that's Trouble Man's Notes 16. So from the kitchen, literally to progress the story, all we got to do is fix the mirror and then we're good. So Trouble Man's Notes 17, ignore the bathroom on the left there. And as we go in this bit, go to the left, there's another door which is open. Directly ahead of you will be Trouble Man's Notes 17, keeping distance. Very good. Keeping coronavirus distance, 2 meters, etc, etc. Yeah, there's a joke in this somewhere, but I'm bloody tired now. Directly to the left of where you just got Trouble Man's Notes 17 is the business card for Trouble Man's Notes 18. Jack Orkin, pure dickball. And then we can head out of the door. Go to the left, this door was already open, but we can head all the way in, go into what is known as Lillian's room. Looks a bit creepy in this bunker. Have a look at the desk, and that, my friends, is Trouble Man's 19 alone. This is where you should get the achievements, and now this is where you should get the achievements for collecting everything. So, like I said, hopefully, if you followed along with the video well, then you should have every single achievement related to collectibles. You can have a look in Lily's room. Couple of creepy stuff going on, but we're not going to be doing that. But what we are going to be doing is heading back towards the kitchen. Basically, just to finish this off now. We're all tired. We've all enjoyed it. We've enjoyed some jokes and stuff, but I just had to come in here because this is where one of the mirror shards will be. And just like magic and just like ghost stuff, it's not there at the minute until we interact with the mirror. annoyingly. So, like I said, head back into the kitchen, which is on the right, the opposite end of the room there. This is where we need to interact with it. So, first piece then is in the kitchen, and it's on the counter behind you. There it is. Lovely. So far, so good. But, you know, we've all had some laughs, we've all enjoyed it, but we all need to take a nap now. Go left right here into the bathroom, and there is a mirror shard on the floor, don't worry. At the state of this place, I'm assuming those toilets haven't been cleaned, so I don't want to spew anyone up, or make anyone spew, rather. And then head back into the left, into that sort of office-type room, and once again, the mirror shard is going to be on the table. That is 3 out of 3. And now, let's go back into the mirror. Let's go and put them together. Let us finish this. Woo! Can you see I'm excited? Oh, back into the kitchen. Again, all you're doing is just putting the same shape that is on the mirror. Very fairly obvious.
And there it was. The moment we finally met.
Right then, guys, so here we are then. We have made it. All we're doing now is taking a short walk to the lake. Again, there's only one way you can go. You cannot get lost. And if so, you can't finish the game, and I'm very sorry for you. But no, you can't actually get lost. So I am going to leave it here, but thank you so, so much for watching, guys and gals. I really hope you enjoyed this game. I thought it was absolutely fantastic. And I'm definitely hoping to see more from Bloober Team, and definitely a second medium game. But again, like I said, hopefully you enjoyed the game as much as I did. Hopefully you enjoyed the guide as well, that it helped you, that we had some good laughs, as we always do along the way. Don't forget, of course, to like, comment, subscribe, and share as well, if it did help you out and you did like it. Don't forget to check me out on all my socials, Twitter, Instagram, also on Patreon as well, if you want to check out the, any of those. Links are provided in the description box below. But that is that then, guys and gals. So, once again, thanks so for more... Try that again. Thanks so much for watching. Love you, guys and gals. You're all beautiful. Big love. See you in the next one.
Sister. Lily, I didn't know. I couldn't remember. I'm so sorry. It's okay. It was better that way. At least you had a life. That day,
day when the fire broke out at our house, I made a deal. The part of my soul that was tormented.
Voices.